to get you thinking about
all this feeling, you know, the slump of this week. But not to fear, we are going to be keeping you informed, entertained for the next 3 hours and also connecting with you on our social media platforms. But two people we're also connecting with this morning is these handsome guys.
The most unslumped hair you'll see on TV. Good morning, gents.
Porter! Yes, good morning, it's Friday!
Yes, it is. It is indeed. It's a beautiful day today. It's Friday then Saturday, Sunday, and then Sunday is quite important because, you know, we're celebrating a great person that you'll see behind me. Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela, the guy is just, it's a legacy that we carry on. And despite anything that's going on around us right now, I was chatting to a psychologist the other day who said that if you are feeling a bit overwhelmed, the best thing to do in order to grab control is to make sure that you do some acts of service, and that is exactly what the legacy is about, and perhaps the perfect weekend for us to do those acts of service as well.
So true, Carl, especially the time we're in right now. It's, I think, for all South Africans and you, Mzansi, watching, such a convenient time to pay it forward.
Indeed.
Give that energy, give everything else that you have, because it's so, so valuable right now. And that aligns exactly with the quote that we have for the day. It's from the man himself, Nelson Mandela, and he said the following. He says, "There can be no greater gift than that of giving one's time and energy to helping others without expecting anything in return." Now, Carl, I must read this again. There can be no greater gift than that of giving one's time and energy to helping others without expecting anything in return. A rare act these days, especially in the world we live in, and what an easy way to just flip things around and pay it forward.
We're seeing it all over the country, and I think these acts of service, it's not just left to one day like Sunday, it's acts of service every single day, and we're going to find our ways to make sure that those are highlighted on your Feel Good Breakfast show throughout the course of the show today. Also on social media, do let us know what you're going to be up to for your 67 minutes this weekend. As we get into some news, here's Jamie standing by.
Thank you so much, boys. Time to have a first look at what's happening in and around the world, starting with your national news. Now, the acting minister in the presidency, Kumbudzo Ntshavheni, says one of the 12 alleged instigators of the violent looting in KwaZulu-Natal and Gauteng has been arrested. Briefing the media in Pretoria yesterday, she added that the police had intensified the investigation into the remaining 11 suspects. Now, some 1,500 people have been arrested since the beginning of the protests. The death toll presently stands at 117, 91 in KwaZulu-Natal and 26 in Gauteng. Situation in KwaZulu-Natal remains volatile but much improved, while calm has been restored in some parts of Gauteng. And then staying with your local news as well, South African motorists can expect a significant fuel price hike next month. Now, with data from the Central Energy Fund pointing to petrol and diesel price pain. Now, this even before taking into account the damage done by riots and looting in KwaZulu-Natal and Gauteng. Mid-month data suggests an 83 to 87 cents per litre hike for petrol and a 57 to 58 cents per litre hike for diesel. And this outlook can still change before month end. Now, prices are affected by the rand and dollar exchange rate and changes to international petroleum product costs. Now, looking to news further abroad, Mozambique has lodged an official request for military intervention from neighbouring countries to help quell a jihadist insurgency in the gas-rich north. Southern African countries early agreed to deploy forces to Mozambique's Cabo Delgado province, where insurgents have been wreaking havoc since 2017. Now, Mozambique's defense minister, Jamie Neto, said this request was now formally finalized. Rwanda has already started to deploy some 1,000 troops to northern Mozambique. And then India has expressed concern about the safety of its nationals in South Africa after days of looting, arson and violence in KwaZulu-Natal and Gauteng. Now, many Indian expats are calling on New Delhi to evacuate its citizens, while others are suggesting India request protection for the Indian community. They have alleged that businesses and factories owned by Indians have been targeted by looters. But sources in the Indian government have said that the Ramaphosa government has reassured New Delhi, saying early restoration of normalcy and peace is an overriding priority. And then next, South Africans to mark a great leader's birthday on Sunday. Now, of course, this Sunday, we are commemorating the birthday of Nelson Mandela, the father of the nation, one of Africa and the world's greatest statesmen, a Nobel laureate, and a man who embodied qualities that transcend this earthly life. Now, to mark his birthday, he was born on 18th July 1918. The Nelson Mandela Foundation is inviting everyone to join them on Sunday as they honor Madiba by contributing to the immediate needs of most vulnerable vulnerable communities. Now, this year, Nelson Mandela International Day will focus on two critical intersecting challenges being faced by South Africa and many other countries. Now, that is food insecurity and cultures of lawlessness. Now, this year, the foundation will be at the Ikageng Itheleleng AIDS Ministry, a social welfare center in Soweto, Johannesburg, for another Each One Feed One distribution. They are inviting the public to donate to the campaign via their Give and Gain platform or by contributing to the Each One Feed One hashtag 4Cans for Mandela Day call to action. Well, on that positive note, that is where I leave your 6 o'clock news headlines. I'll be back on the top of the hour. Here is G with a first look at the sports.
Thank you so much, Jamie. Well, hopefully the impending Mandela Day will inspire a host of South African teams this weekend. Some high-stakes sports from a South African perspective. Let's start with rugby. South African AES side will look to make it 2 wins in 2 matches when they take on the Bulls this weekend. So earlier this week, the SAA side, packed with Springbok players, handed the British and Irish Lions their first defeat in their Lions series. South Africa's rugby director, or director of rugby, Rossio Rasmus, confirmed the much-needed warm-up match will indeed go ahead tomorrow. Thankfully, the match will help the Boks get ready for their 3 test matches against the British and Irish Lions starting next weekend. Then on the flip side of that coin, the British and Irish Lions will look to bounce back from their 17-13 loss to South Africa. That's when they faced the Stormers at Cape Town Stadium. Stormers head coach John Dobson named Ernst van Rijn as captain for the clash, kicking off at 6 p.m. tomorrow. And Springbok centre Juan de Jong will earn his 98th cap for the team from the mother city. That's when he takes to the field. It's going to be amazing seeing him back out there. Then staying with rugby, Western Province will look to defend their title when they take on the Border Ladies in the Women's Premier Division final in Cape Town this afternoon. The final will mark the 4th consecutive time the two teams will battle it out for the title. Of course, Western Province remained unbeaten in the competition while Border lost to Western Province and the EP Queens. The Women's Premier Division final will kick off at 4 p.m. in Cape Town later today. Then onto cricket, the Proteas will be desperate for a win when they face Ireland in their 3rd and final one-day international match playing out at the Village in Dublin this morning. So after the first ODI was abandoned due to rain, the hosts took a 1-0 lead in the 3-match series after they beat a very below-par South Africa by 43 runs in the 2nd match on Tuesday. Ireland will go into today's match with plenty of confidence after claiming that historic first-ever ODI victory over a struggling Proteas side this week. The 3rd and final match will start at 11:45 later this afternoon, or this morning. And then on to football. High stakes as well, as Bafana Bafana will be looking for a place in the CASAFA Cup final. That's when they face the Mambas of Mozambique in the semi-finals at 5 p.m. today. So this match will be a repeat of the 2008 final in which South Africa claimed that 2-1 victory to lift the trophy. Bafana securing their spot in the last 4 after finishing at the top of Group A with 10 points. Eswatini and Senegal will go head-to-head in the other semi-final from 2 p.m. Both matches will take place at the Nelson Mandela Bay Stadium in Gqeberha later today. Then staying with football, and again, high stakes. Soweto Giants, Kaizer Chiefs will be up against the juggernaut that is Egypt's Al Ahly in the CAF Champions League final tomorrow at the Mohamed V Stadium in Casablanca in Morocco. The Amakhosi beat Moroccan club Wydad Athletic Club to reach that final. Chiefs have kept a clean sheet in their last 10 fixtures and will be chasing the victory when they face a very tough outfit in Al Ahly, who are looking for their 10th Champions League and African Cup title. The CAF Champions League final will kick off at 9 p.m. tomorrow. We'll delve a little deeper into all of our weekend sport in just a moment, so stick around for that. But right now, let's see what the weather has in store.
Thanks a lot, G. And let's take a look at that weather, and starting off with some weather news. Now, climate change has been blamed for severe floods in Germany and Belgium, in which at least 67 people have lost their lives after record rainfall caused rivers to burst their banks. Most of the victims were in Germany, but 9 also died in Belgium. The German states of Rhineland-Palatinate and North Rhineland-Westphalia were worst affected. More heavy rain is forecast across the region today. And during a visit to a hard-hit area, Armin Laschet, Premier of North Rhine-Westphalia, blamed the the extreme weather on global warming. He said, and I quote, "We will be faced with such events over and over. That means we need to speed up climate protection measures because climate change isn't confined to one state. Experts are of the opinion that climate change is expected to increase the frequency of extreme weather events." Now, while we enjoy chatting to you about all these South African parts of the world, of course, we would like to know about international towns too. And I know that you are some of the viewers on YouTube and the Africa Channel in the US of A. So this morning we report on the city of Atlanta, the capital city of Georgia, as well as the most populous city of the state. The city is situated among the foothills of the Appalachian Mountains and is the highest elevation among major cities east of Mississippi's River. And of course, the Atlanta History Center chronicles the city's past, and the Martin Luther King Jr. National Historic Site is dedicated to the African American leader's life and times. Downtown Centennial Olympic Park, built for the 1996 Olympics, encompasses the massive Georgia Aquarium. Today, Atlanta can expect times of sun and clouds with a thunderstorm in the afternoon with a maximum of 31 degrees Celsius. Let's bring it back home to South African shores. We can't start the day without including some of our local viewers' sunrise contributions. First up, we have this beautiful image of the sun rising over Montclair and Durban, sent in by Iris Martin. We are sending our thoughts to our viewers from KZN facing the challenges they are dealing with at the moment. Regular contributor Louise G. Cheery from Alberton shared a gorgeous sunrise showing off the hues of red and yellow scattered across the sky. Now, please do continue to share your sunrise photos with us on the Expresso Facebook page. We love to hear from you and see how you begin your day. Talking about beginning a day, it's important to know what to wear. And how do you do that? Well, you need to know the temperatures. So let's go into those. Polokwane, let's start with you. 4 to 17. You got Bombela at 9 this morning, rising to 21 degrees Celsius. Pretoria, 1 to 17. Johannesburg, 6 to 14 for you today. Mahikeng, 2 this morning, and you're up to 18. Klerksdorp, -1, quite chilly, but steadily rising to 17 in the afternoon. Kimberley, 0 this morning, 17 later. Bloemfontein, -5 degrees. Please stay warm. 17 is your max. Richards Bay, 9 to 20. Pietermaritzburg, 3 to 21. Durban, 11 to 21. Mthatha, also 21 degrees a max for you in that area. East London, snap, 21 degrees, as well as 11 in the morning. Cradock, -3, up to 19. Gqeberha, 8 to 22. Georgia can expect 7 degrees Celsius and then up to 20 later. Cape Town, 8 to 18. Worcester, 1 to 21. Sutherland, you can expect -1 to 13. And Upington, wrapping with you as always, 4 is your minimum to a maximum of 22 degrees Celsius. That's a wrap of the temperatures as well as the weather news. I'll have another update for you in the next hour. And you can send me some of those sunrise photos. I'd love to see them on the Expresso Facebook page.
Thank you so much, Carl. Now, earlier, if you were tuned in, you heard myself and Carl going through one of the great man himself's quotes of the day, which really just gets us up and inspired. It gives us every reason to pay it forward. And that's what we're asking you on social media this morning as well, Jamie. The fact that it's Mandela Day means that we're going to be paying it forward this weekend. The official day is Sunday, but every day up until then, you can do something special. And maybe you can even do something that helps change the world for a little bit better, or even just a little bit. And I know myself and Jamie have got a small little plan amongst many others. We've got a hike that we're going to be going on, just a small group of friends, but it doesn't need to be anything complicated. We're simply going to go out and whatever litter we find on our trail, we're going to pick it up, kind of pay it forward and help out humanity, in a sense.
So let us know what you'll be doing, even if it's just for a little bit in your community or around. If you're doing it on a larger scale, we'd like to know. We'd like to connect with you. Expresso Morning Show on S3. But of course, Weekend Sports Review coming up in just a little bit. Yes. And also a dance fitness workout. Are you ready? Stick around for it. We'll see you after this.
Every time you brew a cup of Reviving Origins coffee,
you're restoring land,
empowering farmers, and supporting livelihoods.
So every sip touches hundreds of lives.
And offers an inspiring taste experience in return.
Excited much? Welcome back. It is a bumper weekend of sport. The Currie Cup fixture, of course, between the Lions and the Cheetahs may have been called off, but we still have lots of rugby to keep us entertained this weekend. We've got everything from our national team rugby to the Lions series to the Women's Premier Division final between Western Province, who are unbeaten, and the Border Ladies. Sports journalist Yolulwe Qoshe joins us via video call right now to tell us more about what we can expect in the world of rugby. Yolo, buddy, welcome to it. Oh, so much to be excited about. High-stakes sport right across the board. We know in football it's going to be a big one for Bafana, for Chiefs a little bit later, but right now we're focusing on the rugby. And let's start with our Lions series and the Stormers up against the British and Irish Lions. Plenty a huge amount to get excited about in terms of what we didn't see from the Lions last weekend when they took on a very strong, let's be honest, a Springbok South African A side. What are you expecting will change from Warren Gatland's perspective? Who underperformed? Who's likely coming in? It looks like he's making some sweeping changes.
That conversation since the game that he's holding back the certain players that he isn't going to give the Springboks a good look at, you know. But for me, I don't see too many changes from that side. There's always that the debates around who's going to be the flyer. Is it going to be, you know, Dan Bigger? Is it going to be Owen Farrell? So maybe that's where the debate is. And also at the number seven jersey between Hamish Watson and Tom Curry, that's the big debate as well. So it depends. He doesn't want to show too much in these games. And again, against the Stormers, you see he's got Hamish Watson after Tom Curry in the Stormers. So we'll see where he goes when it comes to the Springbok game. So yeah, it's just a poker game between the two coaches at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, surely Curry's got to be in there. For me, he was the best player by far on that field on the night. Take nothing away from some great kind of counterintuitive tries that happened against the run of play from the South African perspective, but he was quite superb. Let's talk about the Stormers. John Dobson has said that he is treating this like the honour that it is to be able to play in a British and Irish Lions series. There are so many exciting players in this team. One who I think is destined for a little bit of green and gold in his career, Evan Roos at number eight, has been superb. I think he's someone to look out for, but can we please doff our caps to Juan de Jong back on the bench? It's been a while since we've seen this man. 98 caps he has to his name. He's going to be back on a Western Province field, at least. This is magic.
You know, a big homecoming for him, you know, it was more of a baptism of fire. But, you know, very, very good to have him back in our shores. And, you know, I know the Western Province and the Stormers fans will be delighted to have him back. You know, that experience is going to be needed when you play against such top professionals like this coming game against the British and Irish Lions, you know. So he's coming at the right time and he's going to be a huge help for the young players in that team. You mentioned Evan Roos as well. His move from the Sharks to Western Province has been a new lease on life for him, basically. Yeah. You know, he's had storming performances, and every single game he plays, it seems like he's getting himself closer and closer to the green and gold jersey. So another huge test for him. If he can prove himself against test quality players, then maybe Rusty and Jock are looking at him. You know, it's a huge addition for him as well.
Yeah, completely. So let's look at the flip side of that coin. South Africa A up against the Bulls side, of course. The Bulls side taken out of Currie Cup action. I don't think they're going to mind because they get to be a part of the practice journey of, let's be honest, the Springboks. The South Africa A side is very much a training ground for the Springbok team. Let's talk about Cheslin Kolbe for a second. He said that they'll be looking to improve. He himself, it's amazing. It was almost like he was like telling the English players that are involved in this team. He was like, I showed you this in the final. Let me show you again. Goose, goose, boom, score a try. What can South Africa A improve on, and what will they be looking to improve on up against the Bulls this weekend?
Look, first and foremost, for me, Cheslin Kolbe, best player in the world, has been for a couple of months, if not a year now.
100%.
So, he proved that again, you know, against the British and Irish Lions. But when you look at the SAA side, I think it's more about building that fitness, you know.
Yeah.
We showed in the opening exchange of the game against the British and Irish Lions that physically we'll always be bigger and better than them when it comes to that battle. But it's always about, can we sustain that for longer periods? So I think they'll be working on that in the training ground. They would have been grateful to have that real, real test against a team like the British and Irish Lions, because that won't be too different from what they will put out if you've got guys like Itoje in there. But, you know, maybe Rusty and Jock will be trying to incorporate other players that have been previously isolated, and maybe it might be a bit of a mix-up again.
Yeah, and maybe a chance for our backline players to have a bit more freedom once we've built that base up front. Just very quickly, then Western Province up against the Border Ladies, the fourth consecutive time that these two teams have contested the Premier Division final. You've got to say that probably leaning towards Western Province, but take nothing away from a brilliant Border Ladies team that could do anything. This is knockout rugby. This is a final. Anything can happen on the day.
Yeah, like you say, Graham, anything can happen. But when you, if you're a betting person, then I'll probably go for the Western Province women. You know, more than just, I mean, they've taken 48 points out of a possible 50 during this campaign for them. So they're on a steamrolling track, and they've got 12 Springboks in their starting lineup for the game, and they've got 8 players who've been involved, have been called up to a recent camp for the Springbok women's side. So a lot is going for them. Experience and all of that. So you expect them to take the trophy back home.
Yep, a mountain to climb for the Border Ladies, but they have proven that they can do it, and that match between Western Province Ladies and Border Ladies plays out today at 4. You can check it streaming live and, of course, coverage on TV. But stay tuned. Yolo will be back to chat a little bit of cricket. We've got to win this one this weekend. And then, of course, some more high-stakes football. Stick around.
Thank you so much, G. Now, this is an important quote once again from the man himself, and he says that exercise is essential not only for our physical health, but for our peace of mind too. So that is exactly what we're going to be doing now, and we're joined by a superstar in the building. It's Ilona Philander. She's not only a biokineticist, but she is also a dancer too. Now, what this means is that dancing, of course, is the perfect way to exercise, the perfect way to relieve stress, and just to get that feel-good factor going on and give us so much confidence too. So, Ilona, it's so good to have you here.
Thank
I'm excited
you so much.
Because number one, I can't dance.
So you I'm glad you finally said that loud. Yay!
You got a lot of
we'll transform him today, it's okay.
You've got a lot of work on your hands, so it's great because we've got the pro version, and then we've got the rest of Zanzi who's like starting at square one. They can join me, but the stage is yours, please.
Okay.
Feed us away.
Cool. So I mean we can take what we have in the gym, right? And just break it down. So I'm going to do about 3 moves, right? And then we'll just continuously do that. So what are we going to do is we're going to do a lunge.
A lunge?
So, you know, you normally use your weights.
I just threw the hands.
Yeah.
I wasn't even ready for that.
Clap, okay. Clap. Right. Take it down again. Clap. So we're going to do that 4 times. So we're going to go down and up, down and up. Okay, that was 4 times, right? So once you're done there, you're going to swing it back. Use those arms.
Swing it back.
Stomp it down.
Stomp it down.
You're going to go out.
Wow.
Push it out. Go in and squat.
Whoo!
Also, and there
we go.
Wow.
So let's do it the other side, okay? So we're gonna throw it back, stomp it down, out, in, and down. Who would have thought? Okay, can we put that together?
Oh, wow.
Get some
Pop
music.
Wait, we're gonna do all of that in one.
All of that
okay,
in
okay,
one.
Okay, but try this.
Four of each.
Yeah.
Feel it.
Yeah.
I forgot the first thing.
So we're gonna go down.
Okay.
We're gonna go one. 2, 3, and 4. Go again. 2. Okay, now we're gonna go throw it back, and we're gonna go throw.
Just your track.
1 and down.
Woo!
Walk it out.
I'm trying to get it so hard.
Throw. 1 and down. Let's go.
You got it.
You got it.
1 and down. Okay, got it. Okay.
All right.
You gonna do it again from the beginning?
Okay, I think I got it.
5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. 2, 3, and 4. Walk it out. Use those hips. Ooh. Activate the glutes.
Shaking what our mama gave us this morning.
Yes, yes, yes. Feeling it. Let's go. 1. Up, up, down. Good.
I get it.
Throw it back. Up, up, down. Good. Ah, you guys got this.
I don't know.
Come on, we're gonna watch you now.
Okay.
Please don't.
1.
Are we doing the slide back again?
5, 6. Yeah. Okay. No. Okay. First to the side. Okay.
Yeah. Got you. Ooh,
and down, and down, and good. Let's walk it out.
You're doing good there, right?
Can throw some arms in. Yes.
That's
there
his
we go.
Favorite.
Yeah.
Take it to the sides.
Yeah.
There we go. Okay, when you're ready, we're going to go back. 6, 7, 8, and throw. And there we go. Get that squat in. Throw back, up, up, down. Good. Have you got that?
Let's see, come on.
I can't figure out the step
Yeah, it's like
so you go,
stomp.
Throw it back.
Okay, and then?
And then you stomp.
Oh, I'm forgetting the stomp.
Out.
Purchase your tracks
in.
Squat.
There we go.
There we go.
And what's what you have now? I'm feeling it in my legs here. This is the workout. Just by the way, Mzansi, if you're joining us as if you're having some fun, don't forget we're burning calories too here at the same time. And your learner's making it happen. Woo!
Okay, yeah. On your toes. Okay, so use those hips.
Reminds me of an old school dance, like our pitchy.
Okay. Okay, use your arms, throw it in and out. Good. If you feel that heart rate going up, that's good, that's what you want.
Going up.
Yeah.
And pop.
Ooh. Come on, nature boys in the house.
Yeah. I'm feeling the shoulders now, people. Yeah. Feeling those thighs working.
Okay.
Feeling the scaps coming together. This is officially a workout.
Walk it out.
Woo. Sit out, walk it out. Yeah.
But also the dancer coming through and serving us. Thank you so much, Mzansi. I know you love that one. Let's try that one more time. I need to learn.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. Let's go.
Nourish your skin with Ingrams for Men. Enriched with triple glycerine. For 48-hour moisture and no stickiness. Ingrams. Your skin, your brave.
You can do anything. All you need is determination. And a fresh pair of these nalis, nalis, nalis. But what's the point of looking like Injeke if your dreams go up in flames? In this world of doing it for Ikrem, do you want a bank that takes your money? Or a bank that takes your money seriously?
It's my feel-good breakfast.
Welcome back as we delve back into this bumper weekend of sport. It is crazy. So it's must-win fixtures for the Proteas, for Bafana Bafana and the Amakhosi Kaizer Chiefs in their respective clashes this weekend. So the Proteas, they'll be aiming for a win. They've got to get a win against Ireland. In fact, in their final ODI, Bafana will fight it out for a place in the CASAFA Cup final. And of course, Kaizer Chiefs will give it their all, no doubt, to win the CAF Champions League tomorrow. Sports journalist Yolulwe Qoshe is back with us with all of the details. Man, so much to get excited about and a little bit nervous about as well. Let's start with the nervous side of this equation. Let's start with the cricket. Ireland proved last weekend that in every facet of the game, they could find something special, and they beat, let's be honest, a below par Protea side, but you can't take anything away from how good they were. Andy Balburnie with the bat set the platform, but they were just amazing in the field, and SA just had no answer.
Yeah, it's been a worry for the Proteas because we haven't been able to get our consistency. We came from the Caribbean where everyone got their hopes up and thought that we will get to a good place with our team. But again, not much happened for us. Bowling-wise, we let ourselves down. Investment-wise, we let ourselves down. So now it's a crunch game. Everybody needs to step up now. I need to see more from our skipper, Temba Bavuma. Aiden Markram, they need to show their qualities, and I need more from our bowling strike force as well. I need to see more from Nokia and Rabada. They need to come in and take charge for us if we're going to have any chance in this particular fixture, definitely.
Yeah, start hunting in packs, and for goodness sake, put your best player on the field. I understand that Quinton de Kock is a key resource in this team, but it's not like they've just played a year of test cricket. They've only had about 5 matches in the last 3 years. Keep the players on the field, man. Jeez, I don't know how they could have left him out of that field, but out of that team. Nevertheless, Ireland will go into this one brimming with confidence after that 43-run victory in the second ODI. And that third ODI starts this morning at 11:45. Let's talk about CASAFA Cup action here. Bafana Bafana flying high. Before we touch on there, I think it's going to be now their third appearance up against the Mumbas from Mozambique. Let's talk quickly about Eswatini up against Senegal. Brilliant performance from the West African nation to get this far. But Eswatini, you've got to kind of see them punching above their weight class in this one, and they've been amazing as well.
Yeah, very, very good to see them performing the way that they've done. It's always a good, a spectacle to watch when you see the teams from our region, in the Southern African region, perform so well against, West African opponents. You know, they've really punched above the weight, like you say. And, a lot of the players there will be probably playing for contracts in South Africa, and they might even get better contracts now with those performances. So who knows now? They've put themselves in a good position and a huge upset here, they could be making their country proud. So, yeah, I'm happy to see them performing so well. Always good to see our neighbors doing well.
And wouldn't it be great, considering everything that Eswatini's been through and everything that South Africa's been through over the last couple of weeks, how great it would be to see those two sides contesting a final. But, of course, to get there, Bafana have got to get past Mozambique. And the Mumbas, they actually have the bragging rights from the last encounter in 2009, a 1-0 victory. Take it back to 2008 and an exact replica of this encounter. Bafana got the bragging rights there. As an unbeaten team, they've got to be feeling that the system is in place, that the goal is well protected. Bafana, I've got to be confident going into this one.
Definitely should be confident. The Mozambican outfit has been goal shy. They're very, very lucky to come through to the stage of the tournament. Actually, very, very should be appreciative to the head-to-head rule, because Namibia were cruising with 2 wins in the first 2 games, and then Mozambique came in and they got crucial points as well. So, but South Africa have had momentum. They've been the most consistent side. So we're hoping now they'll come through in the business end of the tournament and actually pull through. It means so much to the country. As you mentioned, so much happening right now in the country. So if they would win, it would be a massive confidence booster for the country, and I really think they've got enough resources to do so.
And last high-stakes football game of the weekend, and it doesn't get much bigger for an underperforming Amakhosi in the local league who have been superb in the CAF Champions League. They face the juggernaut that is Al Ahly in that final. They've got 7 clean sheets and 10 outings. They've got the most goals attempts against, a differential of something like 14.2 goals coming at them, or potential goals coming at them every game, yet they've managed to keep 7 clean sheets. Best team in the tournament from that perspective, but they're facing an Al Ahly side that's been beaten once only in 20 outings. How do you see this one playing out?
I mean, we spoke earlier on about anything happening in sports. The same can be said here. You know, anything can happen in football. You know, Kaizer Chiefs have been a huge enigma this season. In the PSL, you know, they've been nowhere to be found. But when it comes to CAF Champions League, they've really pulled their weight and they've showed what they're capable of, you know. But when you look at that Al Ahly side, you know, you look at big match temperament, you look at, you know, a team's heritage, football heritage, as Jose Mourinho would say, 9 times champions of this tournament. So the experience comes into to the fore as well. Kaizer Chiefs, the biggest game in their lives, this, you know, 51 years, never been to this stage of this tournament. So they'll be playing for a lot more. They'll be playing for the country. They'll be playing for having that badge, that stick on top of the badge or the star. So they'll be playing to get rid of all that banter from the Sundowns and Pirates fans who always talk about you don't have a star. So they'll have that in the back of their minds, and they'll want to create history for themselves and make sure that they're undisputedly the best team in South Africa. So it's going to be a big game, but Chiefs have been resilient, like you've said. It's always about, can they get something on the counter? They've got a huge player in Samir Nurkovic, a talisman of some sort. Can he step up in this game? He's proven to be a player for the big occasion, so Chiefs fans will hope that he does so this time around too.
Yep, cometh the man. They're going to have a tough task, though, ahead of a team that scored 18 goals from 11 different goal scorers in this tournament. But we're sending all the best to the Amakhosi. The strength is there. We can do this, Bafana as well, and the Proteas. Hopefully we'll see that South African flag flying high. Yolo, you've been awesome, buddy. Enjoy soaking up all of the amazing sport this weekend. And you at home, let us know where your allegiances lie. Who are you expecting to shine this weekend? Maybe we'll invite you onto the show to have your say.
You know what? Sport is phenomenal, and I think we need some more games, and that's why introducing the Espresso Rewind game featuring 3 of the most talented people I know, Ryle, Jamie Lee, and Graham. You can sit down, my friend. Well done. Yes, exactly. He's all warmed up and going, I can tell you today, it's going to be a big one. So, as you know, we are celebrating a great man this weekend, Nelson Mandela, and this is all themed around the great, great man as we commemorate him, as well as his legacy, and it's time to play our game today. This is simple. I'm going to ask you some questions. You guys just need to kind of shout out something so I know exactly which one. So give me a sound so I know it's you. Did you say Sia? Sia?
Like Sia.
Such a sport guy.
Get over it. Get back on the field, please.
Don't be healthy. No, Jamie Lee, go for it.
Ow!
Sia, okay. Ow, and?
Khaleesi.
Fantastic.
Nice.
Nice. It sounds like a rugby injury. Sia, Khaleesi, ow! Here we go. Stand by. Here come your questions. All inspired. The Espresso Rewind game commences right now. Your first question is, what is Madiba's birth name?
Ow!
Ow! Jamie Lee.
Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela.
Yeah, I'm
sure. Can you verify?
So I'm going to actually tell you that it's actually, you know, that's the name that we know. But I'm looking for Rolihlahla Mandela because Nelson was given to him by his primary school teacher. I was looking for Rolihlahla.
So yes. That's the first thing. Did he say it?
So yes, he did.
It
so, minus yes, one? So I'm going to minus a point from you. And give you. So I'm going to minus a point and give you a point and a half, which means you have half.
Hey!
So that's fine. That's great.
Okay.
Right, next question. Simple. Sure. You're looking for the...
See?
Khaleesi and ow. All right, so between which years was Nelson Mandela the president of South Africa?
Khaleesi!
I'm going to go for Khaleesi on this one. Ralph.
I think it was 1994 to 1998.
Ow! That is incorrect. Jamie Lee?
1994 to 1999.
Correct! Well done!
Oh, wow. I also would have said 98.
I do too, but it's okay. It's all right. I'm so sorry. We're going to carry on. Here's a nice one. I love this bit of trivia. What did Mandela study?
Oh, wow.
Khaleesi?
Khaleesi?
I think it was like law, maybe.
Ow. That is correct. Yes! Congratulations. Well done.
He studied law, and
he actually started SA's first black law practice in 1952 with Oliver Tambo.
Wow. Oh, wow.
Well done, Khaleesi.
I knew nice man one. Was like educated.
Proper.
But, yeah.
Indeed.
Good, wow.
Right.
Come on, man.
I love that we're learning so much over here. Yeah. Okay, let's continue. For how many years was Madiba in prison for treason and conspiracy against the government?
Ow!
How many years?
27 years.
Correct, well done.
Jeez, oh, you so want, fast.
Do you want to answer?
Yes.
It's so fast.
Do you want to answer?
I'm just waiting for Sia's name to be shouted out, that's all.
Yeah, I'm dying to say it, man. It's such a full sound.
All right, here's a nice one. Leave this for Graham. Okay, here we go.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Which prestigious award did Nelson Mandela receive in 1993 for peacefully destroying the apartheid regime and laying the foundation of democracy?
Yeah.
Ooh. Sia. Yes.
Yeah, that's.
What was it? What is it?
The Nobel Peace Prize.
Oh, well, you're so talented.
No.
Yes, yes, man. How did he do it without anybody else shouting out? That's great. Well done. The overall winner of the game is Jamie Lee, congratulations.
Well done. Well done. Well done.
I actually thought you were going to win.
Yeah.
I
was, you were very fast this morning.
You win.
I think I might have been preoccupied with my sound, to be honest. I think I might have done myself a disservice by thinking about
Sia this
whole time.
I think the news headline saved me this week because we've been covering so much about Nelson Mandela.
No,
so
that's great. Well, if you didn't know, now you know.
Congratulations to our winner, Jamie Lee. And, of course, we want to see what you know and love about Mandela. We have a special question for you, the beautiful viewer, and please post your answers on social media as well. The question is simple. What about Madiba's life inspires you?
See ya.
Get thinking, get creative, and please let us know on our social media platforms.
I do love you, Sia.
Everybody, this is your Feel Good Breakfast Show on S3. It's Friday, and it's time to meet our performer. Now, Noza Sichulwana is a singer, she's a songwriter, she's a goddess in a genre she calls traditional African fusion, which personifies blues, jazz, and traditional African music. And she'll be celebrating Mandela Day with a special virtual concert this weekend, and she's joining us this morning to tell us more about it. So please, can we give her a warm expressive welcome, everybody?
Yes!
Woohoo!
Yes.
It's so good to have you back. I mean, the last time you were here with Shades of Africa, now you're back as a solo performer. How are you doing?
I would say it's been a roller coaster ride. Mm. Emotionally, all over the show. Physically, healthy. I'm happy. I'm glad that I haven't got COVID. So there's a lot to be grateful for. Yeah.
I'm glad you said that, because despite everything around you, you do have to take stock of the little things that make you feel complete, and you retain your power. Because I think a lot of things are going around in South Africa. There is an air of powerlessness that's happening, and the only thing we can do is rest on the things that we have, our family, our friends, to make sure that we are, you know, mentally healthy, which is important, and music, which is important.
I think mental health has been a struggle. Yeah, it's been for a lot of people, not just me.
So, I mean, your outlet is of course, music, and you join this great Nelson Mandela benefit concert along with Leap. You're part of the lineup, and we've been hearing some great things about it. So what can people expect from you? Because I hear that you are going to set the stage alight.
Well, first of all, I was grateful that Jared decided that he should call me up and make me part of this amazing celebration. I've actually never had to do anything on Mandela Day, so this is exciting for me. And when I looked at the lineup of artists that were on the list, I was like, okay, wow. Most of them, I've never performed with them. We've got dancers, we've got amazing musicians. And I said to Jared, what should I do? He said, just celebrate Dada the way you can. And I said, well, here's my set. He said, what do you want to do? I said, I want to celebrate South Africa. And that's what we're going to do on the day. It's not just about celebrating with Dada. It's about celebrating South Africa and where we've come from. Even the type of music that I decided to put together for the day is just going back to the old days of Sophia Town into the new age. And basically just saying, you know, we've come this far. And for us as young people to be so privileged to do what we want and when we want to do it, but also with respect of this continent and this country that we live in, it's such an amazing thing. And to celebrate the legacy that he left behind, which now a lot of people would say it's in question, it's an amazing thing to know where to from here. Because he didn't just start this. He wanted us to learn and be able to carry his legacy in every way we can. Some carry it religiously, some carry it with the hard work that they do. We carry it with music because music brings a bit of happiness, a bit of light, you know. And so that's what we're going to do on the 18th, is to remind people of where we come from and why we're here.
South
Africa.
I think we need it now more than ever. Like we were just saying earlier on, you know what, the country's been through this past few weeks. We need this little bit of joy, this positivity. But how do you think this concert is going to just, you know, showcase the arts? Because I think the arts has also taken such a backseat over this past year with the pandemic. So obviously having this platform now, how do you think that is going to be affected?
You know, a lot of artists in every part, they've kind of lost hope. Because last year already was hard, and then when we got to this year and we experienced that, we could go from third wave to maybe to the 10th wave, we don't even know. Some of them have given up and got jobs, and those who don't have jobs, they're at home sitting and waiting for, I don't know what day, for things to come back to life. What we want to bring back to every artist in the country and everyone else who has lost jobs during this time, and those that have lost hope, that there is hope. There is always a light. One would say the sun always shines. So that's what we want to bring back to the people. All the artists that will be performing, they'll be giving the best of their ability on that stage, because we haven't also done this in a long time. We haven't had this platform to be able to share stage with such amazing artists. We want to say the sun will always shine every morning. It doesn't matter if it's on a gray day somewhere, but somewhere else in the world, it's shining. That's what we want to bring, hope.
Hope is so important. And you know what, with this concert, everybody's going to have a message. But if there's a message now, if you were to take this platform ahead of Mandela Day from your side, I hear there's passion and inspiration from you. What type of message do you want to bring across for anybody listening to you right now ahead of such an important weekend for South Africa?
I would say he had a dream. Dada had a dream. He built his legacy, he sacrificed a lot for us. It's time for us to pick up where he left and build our country to what we would want our grandkids to see and be able to experience. Stop telling ourselves that we own everything that we can destroy. We don't owe anything. The future of our kids depends on the way we handle things in this country and the way we carry ourselves. So we need to remind ourselves of the ones that fought for where we are and be able to carry on the legacy.
Power, power, power.
Got chills, so, and we cannot wait to see you perform on the show a little later. And if you'd like some tickets to the benefit concert, get your tickets at Quicket. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ah,
You know what time it is, of course. We're getting the weekend set, we're getting it ready, and we're getting your eyes excited because JP Sebastian's here, and he's got some weekend magic for us to look forward to. JP, are you with us, brother?
I am with you in voice, body, soul, tiny phone cap.
And I see you've got a little bit of a Panama Island vibe going on. I'm liking the style this weekend, eh? Looking good, man.
That's me. Trying to convince myself that I'm awake at this point. I've got a little palm tree. But barely functioning. Year for you, though.
Ah, year for you, man. And year to keep us awake. Of course, you got three new options and something that's really exciting and somewhat of a theme I'm picking up on, but we'll talk about that later. What you got first for us in the world of movies this weekend?
So, do you remember back in the day we had stuff like, say, Conan with Arnold Schwarzenegger, those 80s
Conan,
fantasy movies like Willow?
Adventurer, Conan, loyal without fear, he's more powerful than anything. I could go on for days, man. I'm a fan, clearly.
So, clearly you will be excited for this title. It's Zoo Warriors of the Magic Mountain. I don't even care what you want to call the title. It's the longest, most mouthful thing ever, but Zoo is all you need to know. SABC 1 is still on this trip now of Chinese movies, of Hong Kong movies, for the longest time, and for a lot of the time we've been seeing kung fu stuff, and some of it is great, some of it is just corny fun, but Zoo is a fantasy, or what we've referred to here on the Express in the past as wuxia is the genre. So not just kung fu stuff, but like high fantasy kind of thing. That's why I'm comparing Conan the Barbarian. So I'm comparing Labyrinth with David Bowie. This stands up there with all of them. Now, I've got to warn you, I'm just looking at some of the stuff now, maybe a bit too creepy for the kids. Even though it is like a eye-popping type adventure type thing. But 9 p.m. tonight on SABC 1, you cannot miss this opportunity. I'm not even stating this lightly. I'm not even just saying this on autopilot just because I haven't slept for dumb reasons, watching movies as I do. But you cannot miss this opportunity to watch this movie. It is an instant classic. The director is Tsui Hark, and people might recognize that name from stuff like four of the Once Upon a Time in China movies. But most interesting, I think, in the credits here is the name of Robert Blalock. And who that man is co-founder of ILM, that's Industrial Light and Magic. People who do all the special effects for Star Wars in present day. So this guy previously worked on Star Wars in 1977. Come 1983, he was working on Zoo and the Warriors of Magic Mountain.
Jeez.
Like,
but
I said,
it doesn't seem like he's using
stuff.
A lot of his skill, though, because it seems like a lot of the stunts in this movie is all real. There's no CGI or anything, right?
And don't we miss that? So this was sort of like interesting because it was this blend now between going slightly more digital and staying, as you're saying, a bit more tactile, a bit more hands-on, a bit more, you know, textured kind of thing. So Zoo is this weird break, even similar to where Star Wars was, you know, it's lightsabers and special effects and stuff. But then you've got Yoda, who's like puppetry and all that kind of stuff. So the monsters in here are amazing looking. The set design is amazing looking. The special effects, it's trippy. It's so beautiful to look at. Seriously, it's really hard to find this movie in South Africa. You need to do yourself the favor of sitting down and watching this. If you're a movie geek, if you love all those names that I mentioned, Labyrinth, Willow, Conan the Barbarian, all the swords and wonders and fantasy and all that kind of stuff, even if you're like a Lord of the Rings type fan, this is where it all really started. I'm going to go on about this movie. I don't care.
I've never seen you so passionate about a movie before, JP. Clearly, this is one because you literally, if everybody knows, JP rates movies poorly. So if he's excited about this, then we definitely have to get involved, man. But JP, moving swiftly on, of course, a little bit of a different theme when it comes to monsters. Still monster-ish, I would say. Angry Birds, something that I think everybody is so familiar with. It was the biggest craze of all time for a long time. What's the movie all about?
Did I see your eye jitter there when you said it was the biggest craze for a long time? Were you an addict at some point?
I tried to fight it, man, but I mean, even I succumbed to the Angry Bird for a game or two. I have to admit, yes.
There's no shame. I have my silly addictions too. No, certainly not to what the birds are looking at the moment. This is one of those movies that obviously, you know, the app did well, the little mobile game did well, so naturally there was going to be a movie made. So they could have really just cashed in, been an ATM, you know, collected their dollars and gone. But actually, it's got a really good voice cast. That's Jason Sudeikis, who you're looking at there. Danny McBride is one of the other voices, more recognizable for Eastbound and Down. Maya Rudolph's in there, Keegan-Michael Key is in there from Key and Peele, obviously, Hannibal Buress. These are all comedians who are all solidly funny. And what some of these animations, what some of these high CG type things sort of miss is that physicality is your game. If we all started with the Looney Tunes, and it's funny watching Wile E. Coyote get a boulder on his head because of some weird sort of anvil, a seesaw type mechanism, then if it works, it works. And so this game, this movie, whatever you want to call it, recognizes it's totally a physical thing and it's really not taking itself too seriously. I was pleasantly surprised that I didn't totally hate this movie. Even number two was actually slightly better, but this one is on SABC2 on Saturday at 4 p.m., Angry Birds, number one.
Ah, beautiful stuff. JP Sebastian coming through with the weekend goodies. We are going to be chatting to him later for some more magic to look forward to this weekend on SABC, so don't go anywhere.
Welcome back. You're live with Express as we celebrate the life and times of Tata Madiba. Yes, ahead of Global Madiba Day, where the whole world, in fact, gets galvanized.
Yep. But
let's get really up for a second. This week, over the last few days, our hearts have been broken. We have seen unrest, probably the worst situation in the country since our freedom was obtained. We've seen massive scale looting, hundreds of lives lost, literally. Fuel shortages, food shortage, over 130,000 jobs lost as a result. It has been nothing short of devastating, which is why we thought we'd share these particular words from Tata Madiba with you this morning.
And hopefully they'll give you some inspiration. So here they are. Let there be justice for all. Let there be peace for all. Let there be work, bread, water, and salt for all. Let each know that for each, the body, the mind, and the soul have been freed to fulfill themselves. Powerful words by Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela. And the thing is, despite everything, we're not going to be oblivious to it. We know it's going on. We are your feel-good breakfast show. And we will offer some scaffolding for your emotional support as often as we can. And I think the best vehicle we have this weekend is the legacy of a man that reminds us how proud we should be to be South African. And that is Nelson Mandela.
Thank you so much, boys, for that. Just 2 minutes before 7 o'clock, time to have another look at your news headlines, starting with your local news first. Now, ratings agency Fitch says the current social riots won't have a significant impact on the local economy. Fitch's senior director, Jan Frederik, says it's unlikely that the country's sovereign rating could fall deeper into junk due to the riots that have been largely characterized by the looting of shopping malls. But he has acknowledged that violence could affect fiscal policy. In May, Fitch maintained a negative outlook of the country's credit prospects, saying it reflected significant risk to debt stabilization. And then the acting minister in the presidency, Kumbudzo Ntshavheni, says one of the 12 alleged instigators of the violent looting in KwaZulu-Natal and Gauteng has been arrested. Briefing the media in Pretoria yesterday, she added that the police had intensified the investigation into the remaining 11 suspects. Now, some 1,500 people have been arrested since the beginning of the protests. The death toll presently stands at 117, 91 in KwaZulu-Natal and 26 in Gauteng. The situation in KwaZulu-Natal remains volatile, but calm has been restored to some parts of Gauteng. Now, looking to news further abroad, four people have been arrested over online racist abuse aimed at members of England's soccer team after Sunday's European Championship final. Now, a specialist team is looking into the offensive comments, police said, after three black players, Marcus Rashford, Jadon Sancho and Bukayo Saka, were targeted with racist abuse on social media sites, which is Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Now, all three missed penalties in the penalty shootout defeat against Italy. The government has promised action against social media companies if they do not remove offensive material quicker. And then Mozambique has lodged an official request for military intervention from neighboring countries to help quell a jihadist insurgency in the gas-rich north. Southern African countries earlier agreed to deploy forces to Mozambique's Cabo Delgado province, where insurgents have been wreaking havoc since 2017. Now, Mozambique's defense minister, Jamie Neto, said this request was now formally finalized. Rwanda has already started to deploy some 1,000 troops to northern Mozambique. And then finally, some sad news from the world of entertainment. Renowned musician and former member of the group Sankomata, Tsepo Tola, has succumbed to a COVID-19-related illness in Lesotho at the age of 67. Tola was born and bred in Lesotho and internationally known as Sankomata's village pope. Now, his friend says he collapsed at his sister's funeral. The legendary singer established his name as a songwriter and lead vocalist of Sankomata. Among his timeless hits is Holo Kile, a tribute song Tola wrote after his wife died. Now, Sankomata released 9 albums before it was disbanded, and Tola then pursued a solo career, releasing, among others, the album New Dawn. Music promoter Peter Tladi said Tola's death was a sad loss for the music industry. Tladi, who worked with Tola for many years, said he was a brilliant musician and arranger. He added, and we quote, "Tsepo was also a poet of note. I met him in the 1980s before Sankomata went to England. He was a talented and disciplined artist who respected his craft, and we will always think about him. May his soul rest in peace." On that note, that is where I leave your 7 o'clock news headlines. Here is G with another look at the sports.
Thanks so much, Jamie. Let's start with rugby. South Africa A will look to make it 2 wins in 2 matches when they take on the Bulls this weekend. So earlier this week, the SAA side, packed with Springbok players, handed the British and Irish Lions their first defeat in their Lions series tour. South Africa Rugby's director of rugby, Rassie Erasmus, who has stepped in as coach, confirmed the much-needed warm-up match will now go ahead tomorrow. The match will help the Boks, of course, get ready for their 3 test matches against the British and Irish Lions starting next week. Staying on the topic, the British and Irish Lions will look to bounce back from that 17-13 loss to South Africa A when they face the Stormers at Cape Town Stadium. Stormers head coach John Dobson has named Ernst van Rijn as captain for the clash, kicking off at 6 p.m. tomorrow. Springbok centre Juan de Jong will earn his 98th cap for the team from the Mother City. That's when he takes the field off the bench. And then staying with rugby, Western Province will look to defend their title when they take on Border Ladies in the Women's Premier Division final in Cape Town later this afternoon. The final will mark the 4th consecutive time the 2 teams will battle it out for that title. Western Province remained unbeaten in the competition, while Border have lost to Western Province themselves and the EP Queens. The Women's Premier Division final will kick off at 4 p.m. in Cape Town today. Then on to cricket. The Proteas will be desperate to bounce back and get that win when they face Ireland in the 3rd and final one-day international match, playing out at the Village in Dublin this morning. So after the first ODI was abandoned due to rain, the hosts took a 1-0 lead in the 3-match series after they beat a very much below par South Africa by 43 runs in the 2nd match on Tuesday. Ireland will go into today's match with confidence after claiming that historic first ever ODI victory over a struggling Proteas side this week. The 3rd and final match will start at 11:45 this morning. Then high stakes football on offer as Bafana will be looking for a place in the CASAFA Cup final when they face Mozambique in the semis at 5 p.m. today. This match will be a repeat of the 2008 final in which South Africa claimed a 2-1 victory over the Mambas to lift that trophy. Bafana securing their spot in the last 4 after finishing at the top of Group A with 10 points. Then Eswatini and Senegal will go head-to-head in the other semi-final from 2 p.m. Both matches taking place at the Nelson Mandela Bay Stadium in Gqeberha today. Then staying with football, Soweto Giants, Kaizer Chiefs are in search of that star. They'll be up against Egypt's Al Ahly in the CAF Champions League final tomorrow at the Mohamed V Stadium in Casablanca in Morocco. The Amakosi beating Moroccan club Wydad Athletic Club to reach the final. Chiefs have kept a clean sheet in 7 of their 10 cup fixtures and will be chasing the victory when they face Ali, who are looking for their 10th Champions League and African Cup title, and the CAF Champions League final will kick off at 9 p.m. tomorrow. Well, that's where we leave our bumper weekend of sport. Let's take another look at what the weather has in store and some of those temperatures.
Thanks a lot, G. Let's take a look at the weather news first. And as fires rage across large parts of the western United States, a unique kind of large storm cloud has been forming in the skies. Firefighters and scientists are reporting huge smoky clouds towering 1.6 kilometers, rising over the blaze in California and surrounding states. These clouds, dubbed fire clouds, can produce hurricanes and lightning, which generate even more fires. These are giant, fast-moving blazes, so powerful they create their own weather systems akin to thunderstorms. And due to their velocity, they are largely impossible to combat with certain ground and atmospheric conditions. Wildfires can rip through a large area with so much energy that they generate this firestorm cloud. Now, NASA calls it the fire-breathing dragon of clouds because they funnel smoke like a chimney into the Earth's atmosphere while hurling thunderbolts, wind, and rain. Scary, scary stuff. Now, while we do enjoy experiencing some of our South African conditions, let's stay abroad for a second and acknowledge you, the international viewer who does tune in on YouTube, as well as the Africa channel in the US of A. This morning, we stay in the USA as we report on the weather for the city of Redding, California. The city of Redding lies along the Sacramento River in Northern California with a suspension bridge that actually acts as a huge working sundial. With over 300 days of sunshine, Redding is the second sunniest city in the US. The city of Redding has been experiencing fire breakouts with firefighters hard at work trying to control the fires. Today, the area can expect hot conditions, a maximum of 37 degrees Celsius, so do stay safe and hydrated. Let's bring it back to our beautiful South African shores. We, of course, have some of those sunrise photos to share with you, and thank you for sharing it with us. Let's start with Nazreen Harris Devaluri from Montague in the Western Cape, showing us the silhouetted image of the landscape in her area. Rodia Manuel Abrams from Stays By shared this gorgeous shot of the beach with wispy clouds stretching across the sky, and please do continue to send through the sunrise photos. We love seeing it on the Expresso Facebook page and, of course, on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Let's take a look at the temperatures today. You can expect Polokwane, 4 is your temperature in the morning. 17 is where it climbs to. Bombela, 19 degrees Celsius this a.m., and that rises to 21 degrees Celsius. Pretoria, 1 to 17 for you. Johannesburg, Goeiemôre, 6 to 14. Mahikeng, 2 to 18 today. Klerksdorp, quite chilly, minus 1, up to 17 later. Snap for Max. Kimberley, 17, as well as a 0 temperature this morning. Bloemfontein, minus 5 to 17 later. Richards Bay, a 9 is your minimum to a maximum of 20 degrees Celsius. Pietermaritzburg, 3 to 21. Durban, 11 to 21 today. Mthatha, also 21 the max from a minimum of 0. East London, 11 to 21. Cradock, minus 3 is where you start to 19 later. Gqeberha, 8 to 22. George, 7 to 20 for you. The mother city reaches 8 this morning to a high of 18. Worcester, 1 to 21. Sutherland, minus 1 is where you start later, 13. And Upington, 4 to 22 degrees Celsius. Those are your temperatures, as well as some new weather news for you. I'll have another and final update for you in the next hour. So send through your sunrise photos. The place to be, the Expresso Facebook page.
Yeah, this is the place to be and to kick off your weekend because it's Friday and we've been chatting to you right through the morning, of course, because you're celebrating a massive day this weekend. It's Nelson Mandela Day on Sunday. And we've been chatting to you, Mzanzi, and asking you on our social media channels, what are you getting up to the weekend? Are you going to be paying it forward? How are you making the world a little bit better, even if it's just a little bit? And of course, Mzanzi, you've come through. And Renette Kupker, what does she have to say, or he have to say, Jamie?
Says, guys, good morning. Love the colors. I want to devote 67 minutes to spend time with God, nice, praying for our beautiful country, and say thank you to our South African people, standing, uniting to protect our communities against looting and burning, and also to be thankful for all the hard work being done to clean up. All cultures unite, we stand together. How do I love my country and all the people only in Mzanzi? God bless South Africa and all our people. I love that.
I absolutely love that. The way it's just encompassed everything that's going on right now and how we can just almost just put it into perspective. Beautiful stuff. Now we've also got Mandy Bailey who says, morning Espresso team, as a community, we can clean the fields and parks. So kind of similar to what we'll be getting up to this weekend, I see.
Sure. And Landman says, good morning Espresso family. I give a little food and parcels to the people around me every day if I can, so I'll continue doing it to give back to help people on Mandela Day.
Yes, and I love it, especially right now. So many people in need, so many people going hungry. And then Jennifer Alexander says, good morning, Espresso family. I have an Educare Center, so I've got 300 masks as donations. So I'm going to be handing it out, and I already started it. God bless us all and keep safe, SA. Some practical work there, protecting us, especially during the COVID pandemic. Mzanzi, you guys are doing good this weekend. I'm so excited and I'm so proud of what's happening. And there's so much more of this magic still to come. Stick around because we're getting the rest of the weekend fired up. It's Friday.
Nourish your skin with Ingram's Camphor Cream, enriched with camphor and glycerin. Trusted to restore and repair dry skin. Ingram's, your skin. Nourish your skin with Ingram's Camphor Cream, enriched with camphor and glycerin. Trusted to restore and repair dry skin. Ingram's, your skin, your brave. It's my feel-good
breakfast show. In 2016, the UN Chamber Music Society has dedicated itself to promoting the UN's goals at large through the universal language of music, and they're celebrating the 2021 International Nelson Mandela Day with a unique and a very creative flair as they launch a virtual concert in his honor on the 18th of July.
Oh, it's all of the excitement, all of the hype at the moment, and joining us via video call right now is Ndaba Mandela, Tata Madiba's grandson, who's also founder and chairman of the Mandela Institute for Humanity, to share more about the concert. Of course, we want to hear all about his involvement as well, because he is one of the opening speakers for the program. Ndaba, good morning. Thank you so much for making the time.
Good morning. How are you?
We're so fantastic,
good,
man.
So good.
Really good to be connecting with you. Obviously, during a very special month for us here, and I'm sure made all the more special for you in relation to the relationship you shared with your grandfather and the incredible legacy that he has left. And you are living that legacy right now. I'm going to get right to the heart of this because I think a massive leap forward here, and in terms of the message that you are driving home with this year's lineup, you have included extraordinary black composers, Billy Childs and George Walker featured in the concert. Why was it important for the organizers to include the talents of black people who have made great contributions in specifically classical and pop music history?
As you know, a lot of people, you know, when they think about black music, they think about hip-hop and rap and all the, you know, commercial urban sounds, but they don't understand that black people are very much talented and gifted across the spectrum. So it's important for us, you know, as we try to remind people of the greatness of our grandfather, that he inspired us, but we all have that special gift within us. So no matter which career or path that you choose, you can excel as a black person. So we want to show young people that we have the talent. As long as you are able to focus and nurture your gift, there is nothing that you cannot achieve. And this is going out for all the young black people across the world.
Love that. Mm.
This is really fantastic, Ndaba. The singers on the program themselves, they range from Bob Marley's son and granddaughter, Gillian and Sarah, to our own Afropop sensation, Vusi Nova, who we are absolutely obsessed with on the show. Maybe tell us more about who's involved and the choices behind the performers that you've selected for this program.
Yes, so I met a young lady by the name of Brenda Van Gogh, who's actually in charge of the UN Chamber of Music Society. And she loved the concept of the Mandela Institute for Humanity because we are all about building Mandelas of tomorrow. And so she offered to then partner with us. So one of my good friends, his name is Rohan Marley, Bob Marley's son. And so he then said, hey, why don't you partner with my former wife, which is Lauren Hale. And then she then brought Julian over as well. And then Vusi Nova is a friend of mine that I've known. I asked him to join, and I've also got a cousin of mine who's an opera singer who is actually going to be doing a rendition song from the Mandela Opera that was released earlier this year. So for us, it was really about that family connection and making sure that everything, you know, from Bob Marley, last year we had Ilyasa Shabazz, who is the daughter of Malcolm X, who said a few words as well. So it's really about gathering icons and inspiring new generations. Mm.
I love that. I love the familial legacies that are playing out through this kind of meeting of minds and of hearts, and the fact that everyone has really taken on board that we need to highlight across a wide variety. If you think of the program, it's sectioned into pop, into classical, into South African music. How do you think this variety will allow the performers to really showcase their styles and talents? And what was the motivation behind having such a wide, kind of open, like you say, kind of unfocused lineup, if you will?
Well, as you know, when you talk about Nelson Mandela, you're not only talking about young people, but you talk about generations. And so we wanted to make sure that we capture 3, 4, 5 generations that, you know, that understand what Mandela stands for. And in so doing, if you capture the family, you'll be able to capture the hearts, the minds, and imaginations of young people for them to be able to create even greater as we move forward.
And for you personally, I mean, this must mean so much, you know. It must really give you a great sense of pride to be involved in this unique event, but to be spearheading it as well, especially in light of it being in honor of your grandfather and his very vast legacy.
No, it is a great honor indeed, you know. We mustn't forget that the corona is still out there. And ourselves as the Mandela family, We were also touched by corona. I lost my great aunt Zinzi last year, exactly this time, as well as another cousin of mine. So, you know, it's really about bringing that human family together and letting people know that we, each and every single one of us, have a responsibility to do something for those who are less privileged than ourselves. That's what Mandela Day is about. It's about going out there and doing something good outside of yourself.
Living in the service of others. It sounds like you have pulled together the most amazing collection of, I know, friends of yours, but some amazing artists, and the fact that everyone is driving a legacy, something that is vitally important to them, but also something that is so pertinent right now. So thank you so much for joining us this morning and for all of the exhaustive efforts behind the scenes. I think this is going to be a really special one.
Thank you very much.
Ah, thanks so much, Ndaba Mandela. It does promise to be an incredible show.
It's going to be very
indeed
special.
It's the global launch of the UN Chamber Music Society's virtual concert for International Nelson Mandela Day 2021. It takes place at 3 p.m. South African Standard Time, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Sunday, the 18th of July, on UN Global's YouTube channel and on UN Web TV. That's webtv.un.org. Enjoy it.
Don't miss it.
So it was about tradition, family, home, sharing and enjoying meals with those he loved. So we have a culinary tribute coming up for a man who made South Africa proud.
Made with love by Clover.
So one of the best ways to say thank you and to show love is through food. And I know you know this. Now, I'm not sure how many of you know this, but one of our late great Madiba's favorite meals was oxtail stew. And we have the perfect chef to give you a recipe that you're going to want to try this weekend. Chef Funi from Cooking with Funi is about to show us an easy way, a very, very easy version of oxtail stew. Chef Funi, welcome back, man.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. Eh?
You were on the show like quite a while ago, so I feel like we almost have to reintroduce ourselves.
Oh, yes.
You know what I mean? But it's great. So oxtail stew, I think it's one of those stews, for me, it just feels warm, family, and now we know one of Tata Madiba's favorite dishes, legacy, as well. So that's powerful. But just to kind of start you off, how did you get into the industry?
Okay, I grew up in Venda, and then, funny story.
Yeah?
Where I did home economics, actually.
Okay.
I think I was the first man who was doing home economics.
Nice.
And then from there, yeah. I went to the varsity and then I did my national diploma, bachelor's degree, master's degree in food. And then I end up now I'm working in the CPUT where I'm lecturing and then I'm teaching people how to cook.
Nice. So now that we've got your credibility sorted, you can show me exactly what we need to do over here. So
let's get cooking.
Okay, so oxtail, you know, it takes a while. You know, we want to break down those those protein. Of course, it's a beautiful, beautiful cut of meat. But of course, let's just start us off there, what you have in front of you for those who just need to get the basis of what's going to happen here today.
We're just going to have the oxtail and then we're going to have our carrots and then onions and then the celery. Just to have a nice mirepoix.
Yes.
You know what's a mirepoix?
Yeah, mirepoix. Yeah, it's a good starter. Natural
yes, that's what we're going to have now. But for, before we start, I want you now to mix the flour, the paprika, and the mixed up together.
Got
so
you.
That you can dredge our meat.
And dredging is important because dredging is almost going to protect the meat from overcooking in a way, right? Once we've put it into some liquid.
Also, the color also.
So what do we have here, Chef? We got some oregano here.
Mixed herbs.
And then we got some mixed herbs there. We got some smoked paprika. Is that it there? Well, Chef? Beautiful. And then we've got our flour.
Flour, mixed and then, everything together.
And then
to me.
There we go. All mixed for you, Chef.
Thank
and then we
so
can just go
much.
And do that dredge, and we
oh,
are.
It looks so good, eh?
Yeah,
it's
you know
very
what I like
to have the spices together. You mix everything together
indeed.
With the flour, and then it's gonna give a nice flavor. Now you just put everything in here.
And this is where I'm sure you can get the kids involved in that.
Oh yeah, you,
know, you
can.
Get them
they
all
would
together.
Love to play with it. I normally do like this. I don't know why I
oh, that's,
do that.
But I like
but
it. You know, because it looks
so
cool. You know,
eh? Yeah,
it does.
And then now you can be doing the our. What you call the green beans?
Green beans are great, dear chef. And I think green beans are nice because for some reason, you know, when you are cooking for longer times, green beans do keep their integrity a lot better than some of the other sort of vegetables you can choose.
Now the oil is now drizzling, can see now.
Oh, love
hot.
It.
And then, yeah.
And this is, so what we're trying to do is obviously seal the meat so that we're not going to overcook
the meat, yes.
And we have used, so the oil you're using is clover olive pride. What I like about this is that it's got this, it really is something that would not lose its olive flavor no matter what the temperature.
Compared
and as you
to
know,
because the smoking point also is very good. It maintains
yeah.
olive. You know, you're gonna love this oil, hey?
And I like the fact that you can do a lot. You got grilling, you got stewing with it, you can do the frying with it as well. So it's very, very versatile. Plus, when it comes to the health benefits, endorsed for the Heart and Stroke Foundation too. Yeah. And remember, we are dealing with quite a fatty dish in oxtail, so it's nice to use something that's gonna back you up. Okay, Chef, the green beans, what type of cut did you like on them?
What do you prefer?
Well, personally, I like everybody to have like a nice...
Don't make them like you, eh?
You know what? That's the thing. I am a short guy, so you must tell me. You can choose the Carl version, the Chef Funi version.
Okay.
And I can leave it just like that because, I mean...
Oh, I love them like that, yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you actually... The sauce is
crunch.
Covering it and the crunch is there. I like it. We're going to leave it just like that, Chef.
Okay.
So once you've got that sealed, your next step is, I see you've got some, you know, the liquid that this is going to cook down in, Chef.
The stock, yes.
Yes.
But now, before that, what I'm going to do, I'm just browning this. After browning that, I'm just going to add my vegetables, the mirepoix.
Nice.
So that, and then just saute them, cook them a little bit, so that can bring all those flavors, the carrots, add your carrots.
And you know what I like, Chef, is that a lot of people, the start of every meal, they do the onions first, but you're putting the onions afterwards, because now what's it going to do, those onions are going to be all over the dish flavoring it, and you're flavoring it with the oxtails, natural fats and flavors, which is great. So,
and you know that onion is also sweet.
I love that, natural sweetness. So, Chef, so once we've done that, we've got our mirepoix in, we've got our oxtail sealed. Then we're gonna have this, which is we've got tomato paste over here. You've got some chicken stock or what, over there.
Not chicken stock.
What is that?
It's beef stock.
Is it beef stock?
Yes.
I like it. Beef stock. Bay leaf.
Bay leaves.
Yes.
And
bay leaves.
A little bit of brown sugar.
And brown
just
sugar.
To break down the acidity of the tomatoes. Because
nice.
The tomato paste. We've got tomato puree.
Yep. And great, and then seasoning, salt and pepper, all of that goes in, and once you have that down, Chef, it's going into the oven for how long?
Okay, it's not gonna go into the oven because this is just a simple version of
it.
What you're going to do, gonna add all this, just cover it, and then we'll wait for your, you can go play around, do something else, because it takes a little bit long to cook.
Okay.
Other people can put them in the, put it in the oven, or you can have a slow cooker or a pressure cooker.
Yes.
You know that one thing I love about oxtail is just, it cooks so slow, and then it gives so much flavor on it, you see.
That is absolutely beautiful. Okay, while we're busy finishing off the dish, the result is absolutely delicious. Don't worry about that. If you want to get the recipe, go over to expressoshow.com and stay tuned as Chef Funi, our special guest, will give you some delicious Mkhosha recipe that's coming up as we get through all Tata's favorites for what is a great weekend ahead and Nelson Mandela Day coming up on Sunday.
Oh, you can make my day.
Mzansi's next cooking star? If your cooking makes the pots burn, enter to be on SABC2's new show, Color Your Plate with Koo. To be part of the show, buy any three Koo products and send Koo 5 a day to 072-741-5357 on WhatsApp and follow the steps to load a picture of your colorful meal with your own twist. Mm. Stand to win your share of 500,000 rands worth of prizes with Koo. Koo uzogcwala.
Welcome back, everybody. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show on S3 ahead of celebrating Mandela Day this Sunday. Now, of course, Mandela Day is all about taking action and also inspiring change in any way which you can. And I think now is a time that we need to take action more than ever. Now, Grow Educare Centres believe that quality early childhood development should be accessible and affordable for all, giving under-resourced communities the support that they need. Now, this morning, we are chatting to Lisa Fortman, Head of Education for Grow Educare Centres, on how they are showing support this Mandela Day. A very good morning to you, Lisa.
Thanks, good morning.
Well, this Mandela Day and every day by the sounds of it, and it seems like you have been really hard at work because you've already got an infrastructure during the most difficult of times. Surely this has been the most challenging year for an organisation such as yourself. How have you guys sustained yourself over the last year and a half?
it's been a really tough journey. I think more for every single preschool out there to try and keep the doors open, to try and keep children learning, and to try and keep a safe space for children while their parents attempt to work has been absolutely, it's really hard work. And all we can really do is just to support these amazing women out there that are doing this every day.
And provide skills.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I want to ask, how many learning centres do you guys have and what is the extent of your reach with this program that you have running?
So at the moment we have 300 schools that are already partnering with us on what we call step one of our five-step process. And we have 45 that are already full partnerships with Grow. And the 300 have only really come on board since March this year when we launched our five steps program.
If you can get it right now, just imagine when times are good and when that funding is there and available. We want, obviously, this to be a daily effort, and in your case, it certainly is, but we relish the opportunity, this upswing in activity around Mandela Day, and you've set a special target that you're wanting to achieve. Yeah. What is your mission around Mandela
You know,
Day?
Nelson Mandela said that education is the most powerful weapon that you can use to change the world. And, you know, right now we need change.
Yeah.
We really do. So we've got two amazing projects that we're working on for Mandela Day. The first is this concept of wordless books. We're partnering with Makulu Trust, who produce these amazing books. And we want to make sure that these books are available to every single school that partners with us. They are incredible. They are wordless books. And so children are able to engage with a story without being limited by the words.
The lack of language.
Yeah. They are able to tell the story themselves in their own language, and the pictures are really of a world that they understand. So no fairies and fancy castles. These are beautiful stories that are local.
That are relatable.
Absolutely. So that's the first step. And then that comes with training. So we train facilitators, we train our teachers on how to use these amazing books. And then the second project that we're wanting to do is around nutrition. We want to make sure that every single child receives a nutritious meal every single day. And we can do that. It costs R2 a child a day. And it's possible because, you know, children cannot learn on an empty stomach.
For sure. I love this initiative that you guys are doing, especially with the books. I think this will help the children and the teachers as well. How can Mzansi get involved if they want to contribute to you and the program?
Yeah. So, you know, the easiest thing to do is to go onto our website. It's growecd.org.za. And also social media. You will find us all over the show. We love to be, you know, out there and really
use
engaging.
Use your social media for good right now.
Yes, absolutely.
This is working in two streams for me because you're kind of looking at, if we know if a child doesn't get the right kind of social and nutritional development at this key phase, that they are going to be doomed pretty much for the rest of their lives. But you change one teacher's life and how many people are they going to affect throughout the rest of their life? Why do you do what you do? What motivates you?
You know, engaging with teachers, we do extensive teacher training. So we invite the teachers to come into our office once a month, and they do the most beautiful training. Everything is hands-on. It's all about the experience. Teachers don't do, they live teaching.
Oh, yeah.
You know, every single day they wake up, they engage with the children, they love the children, and that's what you have to do to inspire teachers, is to let them just show the children their love and their compassion, and at this time especially.
And then just imagine what those children are going to grow up to be and do. You can go to growecd.org.za.
Yes.
You can make your donation. If you've got funds, especially if you're a corporate that need to be channeled into something, this Mandela Day, this is it.
And you know, we're back with the feel-good vibes with singer-songwriter Noza Sishorwana, and she'll be celebrating Mandela Day with a special virtual concert this weekend. And here's a taste of what to expect. The song that's called Rain. Enjoy.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back as we celebrate Mandela Day. Now, over the decades, many people have spent time studying the man, the story, and the character of our first democratically elected president, Nelson Mandela. Now, as he embodies a number of characteristics that many of us admire and strive for in our own lives. Now, one person who has had what I would imagine is the unbelievable privilege of capturing these characteristics on a very intimate level is internationally renowned portrait artist Cyril Coetzee, and he is joining Expresso this morning, especially to unveil a never-before-seen private painting of our beloved elder statesman as we look ahead of Mandela Day. Cyril, thank you so much for joining us. I always find whenever I talk about Mandela, it's always a bit overwhelming because you never feel like you're going to be able to capture the man or the essence or the moment or this gravitas that we need to. Yet you've got to do that in a painting. So actually, I can't wait any longer. Before we talk, I'm going to ask you to reveal the painting if you will. I thought I'd be able to hold out for a few minutes at least, but wow. Oh, that is beautiful. Oh, that is stunning. Where do you even begin, Cyril, to capture the characteristics of a man that is so much more than just the individual sitting in front of you?
Well, I think it's very important to meet the person. And I think immediately with a personality like Mandela, you feel this highly charismatic presence, this very empathetic presence as well.
Really?
And I had the privilege of meeting him in Johannesburg at the time when he was, I think it was in his first year of office as president. It was a very atmospheric situation. We were in the garden of his home in Houghton. And my mind was sort of racing from the beginning, you know, how to tackle this. And I sort of tried to ask him to sit in various positions, and I realized quite quickly that wasn't going to work. That he would be the one who determined, you know, how he would sit, and one would have to work with that. Yeah.
This moment of reflection that we are looking at here, how did you know what to embody? Did it come to you in the moment? Was it? Talk me through this moment that you were able to capture so beautifully.
Yeah. Well, look, he was in conversation with. It was an interesting setup because there was a Greek journalist present. It was myself, Mandela, the Greek journalist, and there was also George Bezos present.
Oh, wow.
And he was in conversation intermittently with George Bezos. So he would look at me and then he'd look at George Bezos, and there was quite a nice relaxed feeling of atmosphere. But what really spoke...
So thank you, George.
Yeah, thank you, George. But what really spoke to me in the situation was the way the late afternoon sun was catching him. So people asked me, you know, why like that? But it had a lot to do with the ambience of the garden and the sunlight catching him. And of course, there's the companion piece, the well-known painting on the stamp, the international stamp. And this is a quieter, more introspective companion piece to the one that's better known as an international stamp.
Why keep this private for so long?
Yeah, I think because it was a piece that I'd done in tandem with the other one, and a friend of mine who had also been closely associated with Mandela wanted to have a memento of him, and he said, well, could I buy that? And he kept it private. He didn't want it public.
I can understand why, to be honest.
Yeah. But at this point, it's not an issue anymore.
Okay.
And I just, it seemed timely now, given, you know, that there's a lot of reassessment of Mandela taking place. I mean, there are publications coming out saying reassessing Mandela and so on. And I think it's quite a good moment to see the other side of him, maybe the less publicly charismatic side, a more introspective side.
Yeah. Man. He was a man.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
What is your hope, and I know you paint because you're an amazing painter and you've been gifted these wonderful opportunities, but surely in light of where we are right now and you've had an opportunity to be closer to this narrative than most of us, what is your hope that a painting like this, that a moment like this that you've been able to capture will will foster in your fellow South Africans?
Well, I think for me, and probably for a lot of people still, that's about, what is it, 7 years now since Mandela died. He's still an icon of reconciliation. And I think what struck me about him was the fact that he was a person not only with the universal ideal, but he was a person who had the common touch. He made everybody feel important and special. And I think he wasn't a polarizing person. He was a bridge builder. And I'd just like us to remember him as someone who, you know, who had a special way of building bridges and of overcoming this binary way of looking at things, us and them, you know. He saw the individual and not the packaging, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and we're possibly going through our most polarized phase as a species, never mind as a country.
It's time he has to look again at that aspect of him, I think, yeah.
Oh, you capture so much in this incredible piece of work. Where can people see it?
Well, I mean, where can people see the original? We'll see this painting again. I don't think it's going to be hung anywhere for a while publicly, but, I mean, you can see my other Mandela paintings, maybe go on my website, you know, if you want to see other Mandela portraits I've done, CyrilKutsia.com, just go and have other look at the other portraits I've done, yeah.
Okay. Oh, some amazing moments. What an honour for you and what an honour for us to be able to share just a brief glimpse. And it's a truly remarkable piece. Thank you so much. I feel truly blessed to have been able to speak to you directly about that. So thank you so much.
Appreciate you inviting me. Thanks very much.
Well, you're just going to have to watch reruns of this show if you'd like to see more of this incredible piece of work. A beautiful moment of reflection captured of a man that we, I think, now need to be focused on more than ever, never mind just around International Mandela Day, but every single day here in South Africa.
Oh, what an absolute honor and what a reveal the first time you're on Expresso. That's how we kick off your weekend. And we've got some more goodies for you. Now, earlier, Chef Funi was showing us how to cook a hearty oxtail stew as we continue to commemorate Mandela Day with Madiba's much-loved foods. Now, next on the list, it's umosho, which was one of his favorites, and it's a perfect side dish to go with our stew. Chef Funi, you're going to show us how it's done. This is some good, hearty stuff. The kitchen already is smelling like I'm back home. There's all that loving, the spices, the warmth, and everything else that I'm sure you've been putting into this. So how do we do this, Ryan?
Okay, this is very simple and easy. What we're going to do, we're just going to add olive oil, saute this.
Okay.
From there, you rinse that. You need to soak it overnight. From there, boom.
Okay. So what's the reason for soaking the sump overnight? Is that to just absorb some of the liquid?
Absorb some of the liquid, and also when it cooks, it swells. Remember how the water makes it swell? Also, the beans swell. And then when you cook it, it cooks more quicker.
Ah, okay. Mm. Great tip there. All right. So I believe you're going to start sauteing your onions, and you've got the hero ingredient over there. I see you using the clover olive pride, which I love so much. Now, it's low in saturated fat, which means that's the good stuff that you need, and it has a rich supply of antioxidants, and it's cholesterol-free. So there's that extra added benefit sticking to this box now that we're making this hearty meal as well. And on top of that, the best thing I love about clover, it's also rich in vitamins, which is a high smoke point, especially when you are cooking, when you are making any of your meals. It's ideal, especially for something like this. We are doing this. So is there anything I can assist you with and help you with while you're busy sauteing?
Oh, yes. You need to chop the garlic for me.
Okay. Chop it fine, grate it any way you like.
Roughly.
Rough. We keep it rough and
Yeah.
Now, Chef Funi, is this a meal that you are quite familiar with? Is this something you grew up with? Is this a special one or something? Beans?
Having like normally maize meal.
Yeah.
Which makes from the ash. And then, but when I arrived in Cape Town, I found out like, oh, these people are eating this and so good, eh? And then all the things that I've been eating, the sugar beans, I mean, we have sugar beans with bones and very good. And then,
And I also I love the fact that we're using sugar beans because, again, it's a bean. It does have some protein in it as well.
Very high-rich protein.
Does have. So if you don't have an option of having meat in your dish, like we said, I know a lot of us coming from hard times, sometimes at the end of the month, the parents didn't have enough money, so we had to kind of hold back a little bit. But beans are a great added alternative when it comes to just getting some good nutrition into your meal as well, of course. Mm. So you've got your carbs, you've got your good fats, and we've got some protein coming in there. So already, macro balance.
Done.
Tick, tick, tick. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How's your sauteing coming on over there?
Oh, it's getting there. We just want the onions and the green pepper just to have a little bit of color. And remember now, guys, when you talk about onions, you know, it's sweet, eh?
Yes, yes, yes. Mm-hmm.
Now, by sauteing them, you're making them a little bit so that they release all those flavors and then everything becomes so good, hey? You can bring the garlic now.
All right, I'm actually a little bit slow on the garlic here. I've been slacking, Chef Funia. I do apologize. I'm not mastering your culinary school today quite well. Mm-hmm. We're almost there, we're almost there.
It's getting there, seconds. Getting there.
I'm just getting so caught up on the smells in the kitchen right now.
Oh, it's
honestly,
so good.
Zanzi, if you were in this place right now, you would be salivating. It smells so, so good. Mm-hmm. I've just finished chopping up the garlic. There you go, Chef.
Perfect. And let's put it in there.
Put it in there.
And then just a little bit saute, and then from there we're gonna add our curry powder.
Oh, okay. So curry powder's going in.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's just the good stuff. Yeah. Nice and warm, perfect for winter. Mm-hmm. Warm up the belly and the heart.
And then your stock.
Some beef stock. And while you're popping that in there, let me talk more about our hero ingredient, because this is something that I do absolutely love and I failed to mention. Mm. Olive Pride blend maintains its olive flavor, right? So it's also going to enhance the taste of this side dish. Now, remember, that's all based on the fact that you've got all those saturated fats in there that's keeping that flavor and enhancing this dish. So you can turn this into a dish on its own. You can have it with a stew. You can throw some rice into it. No matter what you do, even chucking some extra veg, it's such a versatile dish on its own. Something beans, more sure. It can work on so many ways, which is something that I love about it. It's versatile. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, you can have it for breakfast, you can have it for lunch, you can have it for supper. No one's going to complain. It's got all the macro balance like we spoke about.
3 times a day.
And you guys can get this recipe on expressosocial.com. So, the weekend is sorted.
Mm-hmm.
How are we looking over there, Funia?
Oh, we're getting there.
Good.
We're getting there. But now, just for the purpose of TV, we're going to let this cook. I've already made something ready for you. Let's just go there.
How long would it take for that to turn into that beautiful dish on the end?
Plus minus 2 hours, depending on the heat.
Okay.
But now, if you soak them overnight, at least if you're a pressure cooker or steam cooker, it will be much quicker. But remember, guys, you need to let the water cover that, and then also do not stir it.
Okay, so let it just sit, let it sit, do its thing.
Slow heat, don't stir it, because most people are thinking it's a myth to say, okay, but when you stir it, now when you stir it, you're releasing more starch, and then it becomes more like jelly, and then becomes like pap. Now you don't have to stir it. Just keep checking it, water, cover it if stock, simmer.
Beautiful stuff, Chef Funi, coming through with the good stuff, serving us up a beautiful dish. Let me run over this side.
Mm-hmm.
I got to smell this. I got to get involved in this. But, that smells good. Well, we're tucking into this, guys. Come through. You can get this recipe on expressosocial.com. But for Funi in the building, that's Umosho, the way we like it. Nice stuff, man. Let's dig in.
Perfect.
Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Feel Good Breakfast Show. This is Espresso on S3, and we are celebrating. This weekend's a big weekend. It's Nelson Mandela Day coming up. That'll be on Sunday. And as you know, over the past 16 months with the COVID-19 lockdown, we have had to live in a different way. We've had to live in a way where we had a new normal, where a lot of people around us passed on. There were so many moments of fear, hopelessness. And I think something as powerful as looking at somebody's legacy can really give you comfort and solace no matter what you go through. And one thing that Nelson Mandela showed in everything that he did was something that I love when people describe courage this way, but it's being scared, but pushing on anyway. And I think that is the most powerful thing that we have done and can do as we move South Africa and our own personal lives forward.
Definitely, Colin. He once had these words to say. He says, "I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. The brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers that fear."
Isn't that a message that everybody requires right now? No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're seeing in social media, at the moment, every South African needs to look at this man's legacy and look at these quotations and actually take stock and really, really find real power in everything that he said. And this Mandela Day, hopefully you can take on a quote, apply it to your life and make a difference where you can.
So true. And we are back with singer-songwriter Noza Sichelwana. And she'll be celebrating Mandela Day with a special virtual concert this weekend. And here's a taste of what to expect. Kauleza by the late Miriam Makeba. And the stage is all yours.
Kauleza simply means hurry up, mama. In the days in the old townships of South Africa, the kids used to run to their mothers, tell them, hurry up, mama, hide everything, while the cops were coming to raid for one thing or the other.
Mama, Kauleza, Mama, Kauleza.
Zanzi Africa, Kauleza, and fix the country before it all burns down. Yo, mama, Kauleza.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Noza Sichelwana serving us up all the good stuff, and of course, a beautiful taste of what you can expect from a virtual concert this weekend at Leap. I can't wait to see you and the rest of the performance. It's going to be an exciting one.
It's going to be an exciting one. I think the most important thing right now is that we look forward to every little thing that we do. It doesn't matter how big or small it is, because life right now has gotten us to a point where we're in a corner, and by any chance we want to get out of it and make life happen. And as I said earlier, this concert is about hope, and that's what we want to send the message out to South Africa, that there is still hope. Each and every day, the sun shines somewhere, even on a rainy day.
I absolutely love that. Well, there you have it. Hope coming through for you for this weekend. And here's a latest roundup of what's happening with the news. Let's go check it out.
What a beautiful sound here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Yes, it's the final hour of the show. Time to have a final look at what's happening in and around the world. Now, starting with your national news, the South African Social Security Agency says that more than 200,000 beneficiaries have been affected by the suspension of social grant payments at pay points. Now, this is due to ongoing protests in Gauteng and KwaZulu-Natal. The agency says most affected are those in rural areas, as they only access their money via pay points. Also, the cash in transit industry has raised concerns that they are unable to move money around, as it's currently not safe. Beneficiaries can, however, use alternative means to obtain their grants, such as withdrawing from shops and banks. And then ratings agency Fitch says the current social riots won't have a significant impact on the local economy. Fitch's senior director Jan Frederik says it's unlikely that the country's sovereign rating could fall deeper into junk due to the riots that have been largely characterized by the looting of shopping malls. But he has acknowledged that violence could affect fiscal policy. Now, in May, Fitch maintained a negative outlook of the country's credit prospects, saying it reflected significant risk to debt stabilization. Now, looking to news further abroad, Eswatini citizens have raised concerns over the shortage of fuel in the country. Now, this comes after a series of violent protests that began 3 weeks ago in the kingdom. Now, some businesses have remained closed despite government's call for them to open, and former Eswatini Senator Walter Bennett says the ongoing unrest in South Africa has worsened the situation. Bennett says it's directly affecting Eswatini in terms of economic development. Meanwhile, the South African Development Community, the SADC, is sending a follow-up fact-finding team to Eswatini to engage all stakeholders. And then four people have been arrested over online racist abuse aimed at members of England's soccer team after Sunday's European Championship final. A specialist team is looking into the offensive comments, police said, after three black players, Marcus Rashford, Jadon Sancho and Bukayo Saka, were targeted with racist abuse on social media sites, which is Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Now, all three missed penalties in the penalty shootout defeat against Italy. The government has promised action against social media companies if they don't remove offensive material quicker. And then next, South Africans to mark a great leader's birthday on Sunday. Now, of course, we know this Sunday we are commemorating the birthday of Nelson Mandela, the father of the nation, one of Africa and the world's greatest statesman, a Nobel laureate, and a man who embodied qualities that transcend this earthly life. Now, to mark his birthday, he was born on 18th July 1918, and the Nelson Mandela Foundation is inviting everyone to join them on Sunday as they honor Madiba by contributing to the immediate needs of most vulnerable communities. Now, this year, Nelson Mandela International Day will focus on two critical intersecting challenges being faced by South Africa and many other countries. Now, one of them being food insecurity and cultures of lawlessness. Now, this year, the foundation will be at the Ikageng Itheleleng AIDS Ministry, a social welfare center in Soweto, Johannesburg, for another Each One, Feed One distribution. They are inviting the public to donate to the campaign via their Give and Gain platform or by contributing to the Each One Feed One hashtag 4 Cans for Mandela Day call to action. Hope you can do your part for this Mandela Day. Well, that is where I leave your news headlines here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Here's G with a final look at the sports.
Thanks so much, Jamie. Let's start with rugby. South Africa able to make it 2 wins in 2 matches when they take on the Bulls this weekend. So earlier this week, the SAA side packed with Springbok players handed the British and Irish Lions their first defeat in their Lions series tour. SA Rugby's director of rugby, who's had to step in as coach over the last week, Ratia Rasmus, confirmed the much-needed warm-up match will indeed go ahead tomorrow, and that match will help the Box get ready for their 3 test matches against the British and Irish Lions starting next weekend. On the flip side of that coin, the British and Irish Lions will look to bounce back from that 17-13 loss to South Africa A when they face the Stormers at Cape Town Stadium. And Stormers head coach John Dobson named Ernst van Rijn as captain for the clash, kicking off at 6 p.m. tomorrow. Then Springbok centre Juan de Jong will earn his 98th cap for the team from the Mother City. That's when he takes to the field off the bench as well. Great to see him back in action back home. Then staying with rugby, Western Province will look to defend their title when they take on Border Ladies in the Women's Premier Division final in Cape Town later this afternoon. The final will mark the 4th consecutive time. In fact, the 2 teams will battle it out for the title. Western Province remained unbeaten in the competition, while Border, they've lost to Western Province and the EP Queens. The Women's Premier Division final will kick off at 4 p.m. in Cape Town today. Then on to cricket, the Proteas will be desperate for a win when they face Ireland in the 3rd and final one-day international match at the Village in Dublin this morning. The first ODI was abandoned due to rain. The hosts then took a 1-0 lead in the 3-match series after they beat South Africa by 43 runs in the 2nd match on Tuesday. Then Ireland will go into today's match brimming with confidence after claiming that historic first ever ODI victory over the struggling Proteas this week. The 3rd and final match will start at 11:45 this morning. Now on to football. Bafana Bafana will be looking for a place in the CASAFA Cup final when they face Mozambique in the semi-finals at 5 p.m. today. This match will be a repeat of the 2008 final in which South Africa claimed a 2-1 victory over the Mambas to lift the trophy. Bafana secured their spot in the last 4 after finishing at the top of Group A with 10 points. Then Eswatini and Senegal will go head-to-head in the other semi-final, and that's at 2 p.m. Both matches taking place at the Nelson Mandela Bay Stadium in Gqeberha today. Then staying with football and high-stakes football at that, Soweto Giants Kaizer Chiefs are in search of that star. They'll be up against Egypt's Al Ahly in the CAF Champions League final tomorrow at the Mohamed V Stadium in Casablanca in Morocco. So the Amakosi beat Moroccan club Wydad Athletic Club to reach that final. Chiefs have kept a clean sheet in 7 of the last 10 cup games and will be chasing the victory when they face a very strong Al Ahly outfit, who are looking for now their 10th Champions League and African Cup title. The CAF Champions League final will kick off at 9 p.m. tomorrow. Well, that's a wrap of your bumper weekend of sport. Enjoy it all. Right now, though, let's get an update on the weather and see what temperatures are headed our way today.
The weather news first, and climate change has been blamed for severe floods in Germany and Belgium, in which at least 67 people have lost their lives after record rainfall caused rivers to burst their banks. Most of the victims were in Germany, but 9 also passed away in Belgium. The German states of Rhineland-Palatinate as well as North Rhine-Westphalia were worst affected. More heavy rain is forecast across the region today. During a visit to a hard-hit area, Armin Laschet, Premier of North Rhine-Westphalia, blamed the extreme weather on global warming, and he said, and I quote, "We will be faced with such events over and over. That means we need to speed up climate protection measures because climate change isn't confined to one state." Experts are of the opinion that climate change is expected to increase the frequency of extreme weather events. Now for our final international city featuring this morning, we remain in Europe as we head to the German city of Cologne. Now Cologne, a 2,000-year-old city spanning the Rhine River in western Germany, is the region's cultural hub, a landmark of high Gothic architecture set amid reconstructed Old Town. The twin-spired Cologne Cathedral is known for its gilded medieval reliquary as well as sweeping river views. This was declared a UNESCO heritage site back in 1996. The adjacent Museum Ludwig showcases 20th century art, including masterpieces by Picasso, and the Romano-Germanic Museum houses Roman antiquities. As reported earlier at the top of this bulletin, the area is currently dealing with heavy rains and floods. Today, the city of Cologne is a mainly cloudy day forecast with showers in places. A maximum of 22 degrees Celsius has been forecast for the city. We do hope the extreme weather conditions ease up soon for all citizens in the states affected by heavy rains. Now let's bring it back to South African shores. We are ending our weather bulletin by recapping the beautiful sunrise photos received today. And let's start with those rolling credits. First up this morning, we shared this pastel-hued image of the sun rising over Montclair in Durban, sent in by Iris Martin. We are sending our thoughts and prayers to our viewers based in KZN facing the challenges they are dealing with at the moment. Now, regular contributor Louise G. Cheery from Alberton shared a gorgeous sunrise showing off the hues of red and yellow scattered across the sky. Nazreen Harris-Davaluri from Montague in the Western Cape showing us the silhouetted image of the landscape in her area. And last but not least, Rodia Manuel Abrams from Strathspey sharing this gorgeous shot of the beach with wispy clouds stretching across the sky. Thank you so much, and do continue to send those sunrise photos to us on the Expresso Facebook page. We'd love to hear from you and see how you begin your day. Now let's take a look at how you begin your day temperature-wise. Let's start in Polokwane. 4 to 17 is your temperature. Pombela, 9 to 21. Pretoria, you can expect 1. You rise up to 17. Johannesburg, 6 to 14. Mahikeng, 2 to 18 today. Klerksdorp, minus 1, but you go up to 17. The max is 17 in Kimberley as well, but you start at 0. Bloemfontein, minus 5, believe it or not. 17 is the maximum. Richards Bay in the morning, 9, 20 later this afternoon. Pietermaritzburg, 3 to 21. Durban, 11 to 21. Mthatha, you can expect 0 this morning, rising steadily to 21 degrees Celsius. East London, 11 to 21. Cradock, minus 3 to 19. Gqeberha, 8 to 22 today. George, 7 to 20. The mother city experiences 8 this morning. That goes up to 18 later. Worcester, 1 to 21. Sutherland, a very cold, minus 1 to 13. And then Upington, 4 degrees Celsius this morning, up to 22 in the afternoon. That's a wrap on the temperatures and your weather news for the morning and your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Do remember to send those sunrise photos to us. Expresso Facebook page is the place to be.
Thank you so much, Carl. Now, with all that weather, it makes me think that there's so much more to look forward to because the show is just firing up. Now, we've got birthdays to celebrate. We've got more movies and so much more entertainment, as well as the Friday dance. So don't go anywhere. See you around.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, yes, it is your feel-good breakfast show on S3. Happy Friday to all of you. But we have to take it back a bit. You know, we have certainly been loving our skin sessions with Ingrams. Now, on Tuesday, we kicked off with a very strong and yet another brave conversation between the two incredibly proud members of the LGBTQI plus community. Now, it was choreographer and dancer Courtney Paul, as well as South African actor and media personality Mr. Simizi Umhlungu Somgaga, to find out their thoughts of skin equality. It was really a beautiful conversation where they just really really unpacked what it meant to them. I remember Sumizi saying he never felt the need to come out. Why?
Yeah.
What was the reason?
I think also the support that they had and that external factor really does have a big part to play in that. And just to be able to be you and have an environment where you can do that is such a blessing thing. But on top of that, Mzansi, we asked you to join the Brave conversation by telling us who you admire within the LGBTQI+ community. And here's what some of you had to say. Now, Dora first off started out by saying, "My hero is my youngest sister. I will always admire her courage. She came out in her first year of high school. Now, I remember getting a call that my sister can't come back to school the following day wearing trousers. Now, I wanted to obey the school rules, so I bought her a skirt, but she showed me the other side of her that I never knew. My younger sister stood her ground and made sure the teachers understood that this is who she is. From the way she speaks, the way she walks, the way she does her hair, to the way she dresses. From that day, many came out and girls were allowed to wear trousers. Now, she is now a part of the LGBTQ community that makes a difference in our community."
Oh,
don't
wow.
you just love that?
Yes.
I love the fact that someone can just be themselves and be proud enough and confident enough to assert that within the world. That is something to just be inspired
by. And also
by.
Taking that brave stand to say, you know what, this is who I am. I'm not hiding behind anything.
Yeah.
This is who I am. We had another one come through from Gary who commented, "To be honest, among so many others who are brave enough to come out, I admire myself the most. Now, being able to be out and proud has garnered so much respect and admiration from society. Now, straight guys at my gym have on many occasions told me how inspiring it is to them to see how proud and also confident I am about my sexuality. Having been mocked and ridiculed at school, I emerged stronger. It was an uphill battle to be a gay teenager during the awful apartheid era when it was a criminal offense to be gay. Now, having the police raid gay clubs and treat us like criminals just for being who our creator made us. I applaud every gay person who can rise above homophobia, stand tall, and celebrate your amazing life and opportunity. You are perfect in every single way." Oh, wow.
Gary, literally
this
an absolute inspiration. I mean, I never knew this about him, and I mean, he's literally like a family member to us, and just hearing that, honestly, so inspiring, just to be able to, against the law, against what everybody else is telling you, that your belief and what you are is more important than anything else. I absolutely love that, Gary, man. Beautiful story. Now, Monica also had something to share, and I'm loving everything that's coming through right now. She says, "I admire my very own daughter, and I will continue to support her till my last day on earth." Yes. Please, I love it, coming through. And I think that just weighs on the conversation that's so important about creating an environment mm-hmm. for your child, for your kids, or for your friends even, just to make sure that they can just be themselves. The world needs a change.
Yeah, and you need that support in your tribe all the time. Now, we are continuing the Brave conversation. It's not over just yet. You still stand the chance to win a 1,000 Rand voucher with Ingram's. All you have to do is tell us about who you admire within the LGBTQI+ community by replying to the competition post on the Expresso Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram page, and remember to include the hashtag #YourSkinYourBrave. Now remember, this week's competition closes at midday today, and those T's and C's can be found on our website, expressoshow.com.
Nourish your skin with Ingram's Tissue Oil and Rich Body Care range for 48-hour rich moisture. Ingram's, your skin, your brave.
Time for a bit of fashion. Now, the late Italian fashion designer Elio Fiorucci said, "Denim is a love that never fades." And I couldn't agree more, because denim seems to last forever. Now, from red carpets to the streets, it's been a favorite amongst so many fashion icons. I can remember Kate Moss rocking a denim number, Madonna, Princess Diana. We've got Rihanna. Of course, Kanye and his denim. He loves that stuff, especially when it doesn't fit him properly, but he likes it that way. So we have our own fashion icon, and it just seems like everything that she puts on just fits perfectly. Nox Mafu to take us through the world of denim.
Yes.
Hello.
Good morning. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday to you. It's a great weekend ahead, and of course, a very important weekend with the Nelson Mandela Day coming
100%.
Up. I think what we do need to do is look good this weekend.
100%.
Okay, and also look at something as versatile as denim, but denim done well, which is important.
Exactly, and that is the trick, right?
Yeah.
So we can all just find denim, but can you wear it well? Can you pick the cut that is right for you? And I feel like with the help of Woolies, we could all do that.
Okay, so I know that denim, the styles have gone through the ages.
Yes.
You know, they've gone from bell bottoms through to strange cuts, wide leg, skinny, super skinny, super ultra skinny, where it's basically your skin. But tell us about some of the new styles in denim.
Well, I think we're seeing, like you're saying, the classics will remain. So we've got the wide leg, which is really doing well at the moment. I'm sporting one of those at the moment. So at the moment, you can really enjoy the wide leg, the boyfriend jeans, the mom jeans, which I think everyone looks good in, right?
Yes.
But of course, there's the classic, the skinny jeans, which I feel like you, your grandmother, and anyone would look great in. So we've got this in a mid-rise or a high-rise, and those are kind of like the classic staples from the bottom.
Okay.
And then what's happening now, which I'm super excited about, are the denim shirts and dresses that are coming up. So these are really great designs which play with, you know, the shoulder detail, but also leaning on the classic item that is denim.
I like that. So that was a dress now.
Yes.
So are you saying that that you could actually create a bit more structure? Could you belt it?
100%. If you want, you could even add like a nice like ribbon there.
All right.
Definitely, because it already is cinched, you know, let's play with it here.
Yes.
You definitely could play with the belt. You could also use this with the polo neck to layer.
Oh, so nice.
It's such a beautiful, because this is the main event,
right?
So you could use all these amazing items actually to complement denim. And that's what it is. It's a beautiful staple to any outfit.
I like what it does, especially with denim. You know, it almost looks like something that even if you pitch up to a formal dinner and you have a denim shirt on, you're not going to be offended by it at all. You know what I mean? It's got that.
It's completely how you wear it.
Exactly. Yeah. So here's the thing about denim. It's also about what you wear it with.
Yes.
And I know that a lot of styles are coming out now. A lot of prints are coming out now, especially with the tops and that sort of thing. So I want to know, when you style denim properly, like at the moment, I see that you're wearing this phenomenal jersey. You've got the wide leg on.
Yes.
So I want to know a bit more about the styling of it. You know,
absolutely.
What are you rocking with?
So I think it's about the cut, right? So for instance, I'll use myself as an example, is that I understood that this is a wide leg, so that I thought a top that I could just tuck in would be a much, because the denim is the main event, right?
Indeed.
So I'm playing with the length here and even with the shoe that I've chosen. But you could play with such amazing items, because remember, Woolies has amazing items that have made
like
with
this.
Like good cotton. So here's a simple tee that you could add it with. Always, the denim is also great because it's got a great cotton stretch. So also, tie-dye is definitely popular at the moment. But can we talk about these character tees?
Okay, now, so here's the thing. Like denim, that stood the age of time, the prints on these, I mean, these are characters that will never fade.
Absolutely. So these are very playful, and I think denim allows that. Because denim is that versatile person, you could have one of these amazing character tees, the tie-dye, which we spoke about last week, which
is also
really popular, but also a great fleece hoodie. So you can use this to add any edge to an athleisure outfit, to kind of keep it casual, or to take it a little bit more serious with a shirt or a jersey such as mine.
That is, it's gorgeous. Yeah. You know, talking about gorgeous, we have a model.
Oh, of course.
And the obviously
best.
We chose the best model we could. Now, this is a look that you put together for Jamie Lee.
100%.
Okay, you can rock it for us. Big question here.
Yes.
Denim on denim. There is a wrong and there is a right.
Yes, there is a
wrong.
Can
we talk about the wrong for a second when you're not rocking denim on denim properly?
So what we're looking at is the right version,
okay,
right?
Okay, of course.
So the wrong way to do it is to put the wrong medium denims together. So if this was the blue denims.
Yes.
What we're not going to do is have a light denim and then a dark denim at the top. That's when it starts to look a little bit tacky, or the other way around.
Yes.
It's about matching the denim that you have. So what I love about this outfit is that the denim jacket is a great black one, and we've paired that with the skinny black, you know, skinny.
Yeah.
And this is great because it adds a lot of, like, it silhouettes her body really well.
Absolutely.
But we've taken the fleece and the hoodie just to give it that extra cool, with some great lace-ups from $2.99, which she can get. But this is really just like a Friday after work outfit that she can rock anytime this weekend.
And I also enjoy the fact that there's a versatility, there's a warmth to it as well. It's
100%.
Winter, and you know what, if you do get hot, take off the top over there, you still can roll with it casually.
Exactly, and the casual element of it, if she wanted to add boots to it, high heel boots, she could do the same thing. Denim is a great staple for any outfit, but of course how you accessorize it, whether it's a character tee, tie-dye, or fleece hoodie, these are always the best way to get the best out of denim.
You know, thank you so much, Jamie Lee. I actually would wear this denim jacket as well, because I know there's a sale, it's a quality sale, actually 50% off, which is fantastic. So you can buy all the denim styles at Woolworths. You can just shop safely in store, or you can go online or on the app. Also remember that massive quality sale I just mentioned. You can get up to 50% off selected fashion, beauty, and homeware items. Thanks a lot, Knox, for giving us the denim lowdown. It was amazing. I suppose it's probably in her jeans.
Welcome back, beautiful souls. You know what that sound is. Down, down, down. It means it's the weekend. It means it's movies. It means it's JP Sebastian in the building, brother. You still with us?
Thank you very much for the air guitar impersonation. Although I thought it was you going to break into some sort of Bon Jovi or something.
If it was more time,
lay you down.
If there was more time, I'd do the whole thing, man. But look, we've got to get into the magic of this weekend. Of course, you've got some more feel good for us, and it's coming through in the form of movies this weekend. What is first up on your list, brother?
So this follows directly after Angry Birds on SABC2. Another person who needs to worry about anger management and passive aggressivity. And is that even a word? Passive aggression.
Passive I like that.
Whatever. Use it, don't use it. I'm clearly no professional on speaking. How do I get on television? Who knows? Mystery. Solitary Man is on SABC2 on Saturday at 6:30. It stars Michael Douglas. I don't need to tell you who that is. I do need to tell you that in the background there, that is Jesse Eisenberg. It's not a small role, but this was before he was Oscar nominated for playing Mark Zuckerberg in The Social Network. Who are you looking at there?
Okay.
Oh, you remember him. He's so great at playing these sort of like nebbish, nerdy type characters.
Am I seeing someone in the top here? It looks like Danny DeVito in this as well. Yes, it is.
Yes.
Man, the legend himself. Wow. That's
cool. They're a bunch of heavy, no matter how tiny they are, I suppose. Susan Sarandon as well. So Susan Sarandon, Michael Douglas, Danny DeVito. That's a top flight cast there. Aside from that, Imogen Poots, et cetera, et cetera. List goes on. However, the story being is that this is a man who is going through a bit of a midlife crisis. In his mid-50s, he goes to a doctor, finds out that he's got a heart issue. Some years later, because he doesn't sort of just want to confront his situation with some grace and go, look, this is my station now, maybe I should take care of my life, maybe life is finite and precious and we should take care of it. He becomes a bit self-destructive, so tries to be a bit of a rock star. Young women, totally out of his age group, sleazebag, runs his business into the ground with bad ideas that actually end up in jail, and then he gets torn between, you know, how do you actually take advice from anyone if you can't just listen to your own body and love yourself? These are probably like, you know, pretty useful sort of messages right now for anyone who's struggling, say, with lockdown or whatever. Yeah. But all that fancy high-mindedness aside, it's probably also just fantastic entertainment. Like I said, those are big names. And it's SABC2 tomorrow at 6:30 p.m.
I love that you mentioned the fact that it is very pertinent for now. But moving on to something a little bit more emotional. I know this one, when I watched it, I literally teared up seeing this man go through what he did. We're talking about The Pursuit of Happiness with Will Smith. I love this one. JP, what are your thoughts on this? Are you giving it another one? Are you going to be as gruesome as you always are with your ratings? What's your thoughts?
how could I not love The Fresh Prince, man? Yes. This is him starting from all ballet in the story, in a way. What was it that grabbed you for? Because this is a true story. Obviously,
man, you know what
know
was at the end of the day, there was a scene for me where he's talking to his son or something and they're busy playing basketball and his son goes for like a shot and he's like, don't listen to anyone. Don't let them tell you that you can't do it. You can do anything you want. Man, those moments for me, it's real. It made me tear up so hard. That was such a big moment.
Yeah, I mean, speaking of ruthlessness, it's not JP who's the ruthless one here. Sometimes it's life, man.
Yeah.
So true story. Chris Gardner, who, as you've seen there, putting on the waterworks, Will Smith, Oscar nominated he was for this role too. That was his second nomination. First one was Ali. And he is a guy who is, he's carrying around these mobile bone density measurers, just as a salesperson to different doctors. It's weird to think of a time when doctors would turn down medical instruments during 2021, but obviously this is set in 1981, pre-pandemic, and all that nonsense. So these bone density monitors that he has, these measurers, these thinguses, they're almost like the ticking sands through the hourglass. I feel like I'm treading on soapy ground here. But with each one that he sells, it just keeps the bulls at bay for a little bit. And he's facing eviction, and it keeps that at bay at a little bit. But these things are running out. And at the same time, he's trying to keep life happy for his little one. It reminds me a bit of, I don't know if you saw Life is Beautiful with Roberto Benigni, where the father is trying to keep the son from the horrors of life that it can bring. And at the same time, has to try and just deal with the possibility of opportunity just on the horizon. If he can just hold his breath and just hold on for a little bit longer. Obviously, the character and the person in real life were said to be an intern at a major stockbroker. Funny enough, those dudes who are probably the ones who cause the kind of crashes that Wall Street causes, but and causes the kind of stories that Pursuit of Happiness is. This one is SABC3, double checking, 7:30 on Sunday.
on S3.
Beautiful, man. Something to inspire, something to uplift us. And of course, JP Sebastian, it's always good chatting to you before the weekend, kicking things off. We can't thank you enough, man. Have a beautiful one.
Love you all. Be safe.
Now, speaking to the theme of movies, we're going to be catching up with another superstar. It's the international South African actress, Kim Engelbrecht. Let's go check it out.
Taking on roles that depict strong and complex and intelligent woman, South African actress and old friend Kim Engelbrecht has been a shining example of what success you can achieve when you put in the hard work. And she has worked incredibly hard to get to where she is. And she's got two very exciting projects that are in the works right now. And she is joining us in the flesh, in person, which makes us even more excited right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Kim.
Yay.
It's so good to have you here.
You are here. Are you here? Are you in LA? Are you in Cape Town? Where are you in the world?
Because I'm locked down right here in Cape Town.
And we love
in South Africa, yeah.
Isn't it amazing how, like, you know, on the positive side to this whole lockdown, how it really has opened up the world where you don't need to now travel to LA to still be part of these international productions. Yeah. Mm. I think that's incredible.
I think for a long time you've had the ability to self-tape at home and then, you know, audition for international projects. That's what I've been doing. That's what a lot of other actors have been doing.
So it's really now opened that scope up, but you are here and we're very excited to have you.
Thank you.
On our Feel Good Breakfast Show. Now, the question I wanted to ask you is, I know last year, the Isidingo, we saw the end of it and that was the start of your commercial TV career. How was that platform for you, and how was that, you know, the legacy that Isidingo left behind?
Awesome. I mean, I loved being on Isidingo. I loved playing Lolly. You know, I've grown up with her. She was a teenager when she started on the show.
That's crazy.
Even though I think I was 20. Started playing her. And then, exactly. And then she started a working career. She fell in love on the show. She eventually got married on the show. You know, and I've made some really great friends, and it's also been an amazing platform for me to learn. You know, soapies that South Africans make, we're really good at it, you know? Yeah. We're very good at that,
it's our pocket,
at that genre, yes. So, yeah, so I've actually learned how to work on a set, how to work with big and great actors on that set.
I learned very quickly. I played a cameo very briefly on that set and had the most amount of fun, apart from the fact that I was Emmanuel Custis's romantic lead for about three episodes, which was you know, a joy in and of itself. But the generosity, working with Chris Beasley and yourself and Manu, and how generous you were with each other in that space and acting, how important was it for you learning those lessons on set and becoming an actor that shares and collaborates in that
space? Of an ensemble. I think I was very lucky. You know, I think when I started in Isidingo, I was probably one of the weakest ones there, and everybody around me was strong. You know, so you kind of learn from him, like you were saying, and they kind of bring you up and you kind of learn from them. And also, I think the feeling on set with the Bullers that you were part of, it was a kind of family. It was family, you know, and you are generous with your time because you really want them to shine. You want everybody to shine on set.
And it works.
Will you ever go back to acting?
I'd love it. Well, if Emmanuel's waiting for another romantic lead, I'm saying that I'd fill that role, man.
Well, we are loving seeing all the work that you've been working on, including that made a premiere at the Monte Carlo Television Festival, Reka. How was that experience for you?
That was incredible, just to be seen by the rest of the world, to be seen by the international public, you know what I mean? It's in its 60th year, the Monte Carlo TV Festival. Just to premiere on that scale was insane. I wish we could have gone.
I know, it would have been so cool if you could have been there.
Yeah, but well, we did it satellite by
Zoom.
As
everyone has had to adapt, what was it like working with Ian Glenn?
Incredible. I mean, I don't think anybody can say anything negative about him. He's amazing and he's incredible. I remember I was so nervous meeting him.
He seems so intense. All of
yes,
the roles
I mean, I'm a huge.
So
I mean, I'm sure you're a Game of Thrones fan and you've seen him in that role. And just to be told that I was gonna work with him was incredible. And then, you know, working with him in the flesh was great. But he was very generous. You know, he was like, okay, we're gonna learn some lines. And he was cool to learn lines and go over the character. He loved the character and he really immersed himself in, it's a very dark and twisted character that he plays. But I don't think anybody could have done it the way that he did it.
And your character? bring her to life for us?
Okay. Basically, Reika is about a broken criminal profiler on the hunt for a serial killer in KwaZulu-Natal. But she's also got this crazy past that obviously involves Ian Glenn. She was taken when she was 12 years old by a banana farmer and held captive for a few years. So it's a little bit crazy.
It's dark, yeah.
And then she escapes. And a little bit later on in her life, she becomes a criminal profiler using all of this tragic past of hers to help her be a better... be a better criminologist.
Did you enjoy
like
that role?
I feel like you're profiling you right now. I can just see you.
It's so crazy cool. Because you start actually tuning yourself into that kind of a mind frame. You do like
you
start
got it,
sussing
yeah.
people out a little bit, you know?
So can you tell when someone's lying or not being honest?
I don't know. I didn't even know if I could tell if I'm lying, you know? But it was definitely interesting. It was definitely interesting to be like learning about people's personality types, their behavior, why they do certain things, and also how people, you can't really box them. And once you box them, they're out of a box, and then it's...
As an actress, that must mean adding layers to your own performance while you're thinking out loud. But you've got to take it that deep. I've got to ask, Ridley Scott's sci-fi drama Raised by Wolves just looks like the coolest production to be a part of. I think every sci-fi geek, myself included, is looking at this thinking, this is just the coolest idea. I wish I could be a part of that. You're a part of it. What is that, that like? And to be able to do it here.
Very lucky, very lucky. I was actually on set doing Reika while I was auditioning for that. And then I got the call that I got it, and I was just elated because, I mean, everybody's a fan of his, you know, Gladiator, Blade Runner, all of those epic, huge science fiction, you know, at its purest.
Yeah.
And just to be part of that. He was here directing on season one. I didn't get to work with him on season two. I'm not working with him, which is a big, big, big shame.
But it's still an international production. How would you... Is it even possible to compare international productions with local productions? Has there been a bit of growth from a South African perspective?
It feels like we're doing special stuff at the moment.
I think so. I mean, there's a lot more content. It's also raising the bar for all of these actors. They're doing big stunts. There's, you know, explosions in our TV shows now. I was also saying a little bit earlier that the more we do, you know, the more we make, the more confident we become, the better our skills become. Yeah.
The writing gets so much better as well. I just feel like there's like a self-belief and a confidence. What's next for you? You seem like them out of all of those amazing actors and actresses that have gone over to the other side of the pond. Where's your mindset at?
I think I'm always just on the move, you know. I'm a little bit of a gypsy and I'm always searching and trying to challenge myself. I was definitely on my way back to the States and then the pandemic hit and then everybody was on a lockdown, and luckily I've been able to do projects here, you know, during that time. I think my management are on the lookout for some really cool projects. There are a few that I have on the table. I'll just see what happens next. It's a crazy time. You don't want to rush yourself too much. You don't want to put yourself under too much pressure. You know?
We'll just have to allow time to tell.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And play golf and play lots of golf.
Yeah,
play lots of golf.
Well, Kim, it was so great having you here.
Thank you very much.
Just gracing us
incredible.
With your presence. So do you. Thank you.
You look incredible.
Thank you. Okay. And I've been profiled as well. I feel like I've been profiled. We're always so excited to see you doing your thing. You always make it look so effortless, but I know that a lot of effort does go into it behind the scenes, and you've worked incredibly hard to get just. We are so proud of you, man. We are so proud of you. You just keep doing this amazing work, and I cannot wait to watch the latest. And of course, South African audiences get to do that. We can't be prouder as we salute her incredible achievements. And I think all of these amazing South African actors that are doing the most on the global stage right now, we need that kind of inspiration. So thank you, girl. You're a superstar.
I've never seen Graham that happy to be part of an interview. Zoe on one side, Kim Engelbrecht on the other side. That man was as happy as I was. Thanks a lot to Kim for joining us on the show. And now for some super talent, more of it on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Now these guys, I mean, they've been a part of so many of the live broadcasts. They've been outside doing their thing and they've been absolutely incredible. And now 2 years later, they're actually back and even stronger than ever. Can we just give Groove Tech Crew a massive espresso welcome? Yes, Groove Tech. So Leroy is the man, you know, he's, you know, you are the leader of the group. Is that the leader of the pack?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is it the pack, a group, or a crew?
What if you want to? I think family is what we push towards.
Family?
I think family is what
you're the head of the family.
100%.
Okay,
the winner.
It's been a while. What you guys been up to?
It's been a while and it's been tough, I guess.
Yeah.
But I think we just started to adapt with everything that's been happening, because 1 week you can do this, the next week you can't do it, and then so it's a continuous up and down. But I guess the constant is that we still love what we do, so that pushes us ideally through this past 2 years. And so, yeah, yeah.
You guys have been super active. I know that you're quite a unique crew. Just a quick one about your outreach programs in Robertson, because I know you guys have been very, very powerful in that space.
What happened was I got the opportunity to go to Robertson and work in McGregor, actually,
yes,
just 20 minutes from Robertson. So being in Cape Town and being Cape Town, what it is, going to a small palasi, you have to adapt and you have to understand that what actually makes sense there is far from what actually is sense here, you know what I mean? So, but also the impact that I could do there is nothing I could experience in Cape Town, to understand. So yeah,
wow.
For the last 6 months, I've been living in McGregor, been working in McGregor.
Well, thank you so much for doing your bit for the community. 100%. Now do your bit for getting the GS going. And
100%.
If you feel good, are you guys ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, this Khoi with Groove Tech Crew.
There you go, let's go.
Breakfast Show.
It has the power to inspire. It has the power to unite people in a way that little us does. It speaks to youth in a language they understand. Sport can create hope where once there was only despair. It is more powerful than governments in breaking down racial barriers. It laughs in the face of all types of discrimination.
Na me complain was say no use to car no. Cause I yana what the Panamera na kofani nuya kabute na what the key na koma bracho. And see my kuma bay and I'm a but you know how far get one power one share. It would be I yana grow with me, so I'm really taking a piss. Then me kind of the one pay. And see me so the one I grew, I was it. Me person me be a jar. Watch my swatch and I go swimming now in it. What the kaki in the dance, me person me so the moon pa. The best be on a coast or your bay. All I gotta do is take your hand and run away. Puppy go your car and I'm tired. Also, chinema, when I'm in bed, they be the baby, but now you're late. I don't go look at your face. Get.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, everybody. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Guys, do you know what time it is?
Yeah, birthday.
It's time to wish you a happy birthday.
Yeah.
Happy birthday. Have a happy birthday. Happy birthday. A very happy birthday to you.
That feeling, it is Friday, and you know Fridays are all about dancing in the field on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. So we asked to send in your best birthday dance videos to celebrate yourself or maybe even a loved one. And every single week, you guys just bring it in.
Yes.
Check this one out.
Here we go. See, fun sitters, there's no sitting here, only dancing.
She's standing, girl. I'm ready to go right now.
Ready to go right now.
You see, that's it. Look at the when the curtains make the perfect backdrop.
Look at that swag. Yeah. That shoulder roll for me, that's what I'm about.
Go, Essay.
Oh, yes, Essay.
Hola, Essay.
Not lying. Yeah.
Hola, Essay. Gracias. Hey.
Como, como,
como. With a quick step. Quick
yes,
feet.
That's it. That's it.
Hey.
Wow.
From the top, make it drop.
Oh, the
top. Okay.
Yay! The glute activation, core control, scapular control.
Hannah.
Good form.
Make it drop. Okay, Keisha.
Hey!
Hey!
Keisha has a rubber spine. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Oh, Mason and Mia.
Shake it,
Jamie Lee inspired!
It's Jamie Lee! Look at what you're doing to the kids!
Wow!
Tobeka, here we go.
Tobeka, hey, Leka.
Here we go. Hey, all of them. That's Tobeka. Yolanda, Hermanus. Hi, hi. Yes, yes. Make the vibe retreat work for you.
What did you say? Make the what?
Make the vibe retreat work for you. That's the backdrop of backdrops. If you don't have vibe retreat in your dance video, we're not accepting it.
Wow.
Absolutely just love how you guys send in these amazing videos every week. Clearly you can see how much it makes us smile. So please, please, please keep them coming. Now this week our favorite video was from Boipelo Kekana in Mamelodi, Pretoria. And let's take a look at this. You're gonna love it.
With the fire emojis in there as well. My pillow, my pillow, Janissa, Janissa.
This is not fair, guys. How do these people get born with no like bones? How do you get that bend? How?
You see, when you stop intermittent fasting, the bend happens. That's it.
Well played. I see you.
No, we actually have a boy on the line right now. A very good morning to you.
Hey.
We are just going to keep screaming. Listen, your dance moves, even got Ryle to try your dance moves. We can't do that. But happy birthday. Where did you learn those dance moves?
Thank you very much.
Where did you learn those dance moves? Because, girl, you got it all.
I'm a big fan of Common Pillar and Curly Mesh, so I always watch their dance videos. That's what inspired me.
Looks like you're going to be as big a superstar than both of them with those moves. Absolutely loving it. And guess what? On top of your birthday, you've won something special. We're giving you a 500 Rand cash prize.
Yeah!
Surely you can give us a little birthday victory dance. Come on, send us off into the weekend. Kickstart it off for us, surely.
Don't be shy. Thanks so much, Othello. Well done. $500. Do remember, we're running a weekly competition where you can win yourself $500 in cash. For celebrating your birthday, all you need to do is send us a beautiful birthday dance video on this number, 071-640-6551, to enter. Best Dance Moves wins. Terms and conditions, you can find that on expressoshow.com. Get dancing.
Oh, man, some great birthday celebrations. Now we're going to round off our Mandela Day celebrations because it's a man's life that needs to be celebrated. Yes, commemorated. Yes, it should lead to inspiration for us all, but we need to celebrate the best of his life as well. Chef Funi is here to help us do exactly that, whipping up what we understand is one of his favorite desserts in the world. We are going to be making a beautiful strawberry trifle, and this is indulgent. And Chef Funi, this is the right way to round off our menu, and you've cooked some amazing things for us this morning, but this is something special.
Okay, now, this is so good. We used to have this on Christmas Day, eh?
Yes,
now, Christmas, we're celebrating now. Let's
Christmas
celebrate
in July, Mandela. Baby.
Yes, completely. Let's get going. Okay.
Okay, so you're going to put me to work, so I'm ready to help you in whatever way I can. What do you need?
Okay, I think you have muscles. Okay, you're going to just whip the cream until it becomes stiff.
Okay.
And then what I'll be doing, I'm going to just start plating my trifle in a jar. And the good thing about this, you can also take it wherever you want to go. So yeah, you can just take the jar.
I love it. We call it jarcuterie.
Jarcuterie,
which has become a thing on Instagram. And we've been doing it with all sorts of, like, you can do crudités, fun things. It just lends itself.
You're not doing it right. You're not doing it right.
Okay, show
you
me,
need
show
to
me.
Go like that, you see?
Yeah.
You're incorporating the air that's going to make it...
You make it look so smooth and easy,
now you
man.
Go like that knot.
Okay.
All right.
Did you check how he
exercise. How yes, you're getting there. That's
there we
that's
go.
So good, man.
Now, of course, I'm going to be covered in cream by the end of it. Oh, there we look at
you
that.
You see
that? Look at that. Beautiful. Okay, so we've got our beautiful
trifle
layer. Number two is going in, and this is just normally made jelly, yeah?
Very rich in protein, eh?
I'm not going to call it a high protein. Hey, that's looking pretty good.
You're getting there.
Cool.
Yeah, it looks much good.
It is giving me a good workout. And if you want to create with us one of Tata Madiba's favorite desserts and an indulgent one at that, you can go to expressoshow.com and have a look there. We're going to have all of the recipes that we've whipped up with Chef Funi today. Okay, how's that?
Looks so good, eh?
Perfect.
You can also do yours while
I'm going to
some layers, and I'm just going to cut my strawberries. I'm going to just make it a fan. You know what's a fan?
A fan? No, show me, show me.
Okay, you just slice your strawberries like that.
Nice.
Cool. And then look at it. How beautiful is this?
Oh, wow.
Create a fan, man.
When you create, do you prefer sweet or savory? Because you've given us a taste of both. What is your favorite indulgence?
I think I'm a sweet person.
Really? I think it's
and
obviously...
You?
I'm definitely a savory, but this might win me over.
You would love
this might just be that indulgence that I've been waiting for. So you went in with a little bit of peach, okay. Oh, this is lovely. Okay.
Okay.
Then what's the next
layer? Now you're going to put the custard.
The custard there.
Yes. And then you're going to finish it off with the cream. Oh, it's going to look so good, man.
Yeah, let me do it again. Oh, beautiful.
Oh, it looks so good, eh?
There
you can also finish mine.
I'm going to pop in some custard for you.
Yeah. And if you want, we can put maybe strawberries in the layer again, and then we finish it off. Yeah,
some more cream. I love it. And this is, I think, an inspired way to, you know, let your own personality shine through. So if you want to create something, you can use slightly smaller jars, let people finish it off for like a dinner party. This is a great way of individualizing the dessert for each person, giving them something special.
And you can even take it outside. Eh? You can go picnic on it.
I absolutely love it.
Nice
you could do every course in a jar, and it's going to be easy and absolutely accessible and beautiful. Okay, so we're going to round it off now with a little bit of cream. Thanks, man.
Yeah, we just put cream.
Like this. I must say, this is a lot of fun so good. To mm-hmm. create.
Even kids will love this.
Yeah, exactly. My son, unlike me, has a very sweet tooth. Mm-hmm. And this is right up his alley. He would absolutely love that. How's that?
Looking good. And then finish it off with your strawberry.
Beautiful strawberry. Ugh, you are...
And then you can close your jar. Go wherever
sorted.
You want to go.
Yeah. And, yeah, I think we've got enough here to go around. We'll feed the whole studio today. This is one of those that's not going to last very long in this mm-hmm. studio. Chef Winnie, you've been amazing today. Thank you so much for sharing your love of the culinary arts. It really has been a pleasure having you on set, man. You're an absolute legend.
Doribua.
Oh, man.
You know, Doribua.
Doribua.
Mm-hmm. Okay, the Macheron.
The Macheron.
Macheniabudi.
I love it, man. You can find this on expressoshow.com. Go and be inspired by one of the meals that Tata Madiba absolutely adored.
If you eat, sleep, and dream of baking, enter the Tastemaster SA's new season starting in September on SABC2. Grow your career in TV and as a baking influencer and stand to win 20,000 rands cash plus 50,000 rands worth of premium kitchen products. To enter, share a video of you baking a wonder you've created with tried and trusted Royal Baking Powder. Upload your video and complete your application on the tastemaster.co.za website. Entries close Sunday, 25th July. T's and C's apply.
It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show Expresso here on S3, and stand by for another dance performance by these amazing guys. They're called Groove Tech Crew.
Oh, not us.
Stand by, we're gonna dance with them. Groove Tech Crew, take it away.
I can't feel myself, I don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my shining star, my guiding light, my love fantasy. There's not a minute, hour, day or night that I don't love you. You're at the top of my list, cause I'm always thinking of you. I still remember in the days when I was scared to touch you, how I spent my day dreaming, planning how to say I love you. You must have known that I had feelings deep enough to swim in. That's when you opened up your heart and you told me to come and go.
Thank you.
formally wanna represent. Up in the flight deck just to see the tech. Diamonds on my neck, feeling cold, what the heck? I'm just chasing checks, me free, please double check. Get out my way, my day. Keep my eyes wide open every time I pray. Blow trees, always blow.
Say it with steaming hot breakfasts, soul food sundaes, and slow cooked dinners that will warm any winter. Made with love by Clover.
Another feel good production.
Always fresh clothes on my back. Shit, what's in the backpack? I'm on the road chasing big checks. We want money, want big stacks. We want money, want big racks.